Association. This is the Platte Valley Company's pregame show, brought to you by Platte Valley Companies, your premier provider of financial services. Live from the Logos broadcast booth, here is Zach McKinstry.
Welcome into the Logos broadcast booth. I'm Zach McKinstry here on the Platte Valley Company's pregame show in Gehring, Nebraska, Oregon Trail Park Stadium, as we get set for first pitch of Game 3 between the Western Nebraska Pioneers and the Casper Horseheads. An eventful one last night, as it was an absolute thriller here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium as the Pioneers walked it off against the Casper Horseheads. Let's recap that one. Casper opened the scoring in the top of the second inning on an RBI double. The Pios would answer on JT Walden's first extra base hit of the year, a double into the left center field. And scoring continued in the fourth inning when Casper took another one-run lead on a Brooks Browning RBI double, which was inches away from clearing the fence. But again, the Pios would answer in the bottom of the fifth, tying it at two when Clay Cutter beat out a potential double play and reached first, allowing the run to score. And though the game was tied at two entering into the seventh, the Pios had only two hits compared to the Horseheads' three, and the final three innings would change that rate dramatically. Casper's two-run top of the seventh would be answered by three more Western Nebraska runs, highlighted by a solo shot from Walden. The Pios added an insurance run and were three outs away from victory, leading 6-4 going into the ninth. And Casper Horseheads would not go down without a fight. The Horseheads played it three to take the lead after a one-out, two-RBI bloop single from Christian Lopez, and the momentum shifted completely heading into the bottom of the ninth. Owen Vantillo came into the game. He attends WNCC in Scotts Bluff, and he went back out to pitch the bottom of the ninth, try to earn the win. And after a ground out and strikeout, he was one pitch away from securing that victory on a 3-2 pitch to soon-to-be Gonzaga Bulldog Cade McGee. But that 3-2 pitch was sent over the left field wall to tie the game. The Pioneers dugout erupted and kept going. Tyler Davis worked another two-out 3-2 count and roped a double into center field. And Dalton Frank stepped up and won the game with a 2-2 curveball, which was driven deep into left center field. And it resulted in a walk-off two-run home run. The Pios would win that one by a score of 9-7. And they look now to sweep the Casper Horseheads here in Game 3. As on the mound for the Pios, it's Caden Edwards, who has two starts on the year, two no decisions. The first of the year, three innings of work, two hits, two earned runs, two walks, and seven strikeouts against the Casper Horseheads. His second outing had the no decision as well. Five innings of work, three hits allowed, one earned run, two walks, and five strikeouts. And opposing him in the other dugout, it's Jerzen Morales, the pitcher from Western Nebraska Community College. He's had three outings on the year. His first came in relief against these Pioneers in the first series of the year. He had two innings of work, allowed two hits on one earned run, and four strikeouts in the first game of the year, and the only win the Horseheads have mustered against the Pioneers. Second outing was his first start for the Horseheads. Five innings of work, one earned run on two hits, no walks, and seven strikeouts. But that one earned run was enough for the Tommyknockers to take them down. So he got the loss in that one and got the win in his second start in five innings of work. Three earned runs allowed, four hits, three walks, and four strikeouts. So excited to see that good pitching matchup coming up. Let's go ahead and look at the standings currently in the Expedition League. Right now, the Fremont Moo at 11-2 in the Clark Division after their first loss in 11 games yesterday. Spearfish at 9-3. The Pios half a game back of them at 9-4, and two games back of first place Fremont. Pierre follows them at 6-5. Hastings at 4-9. The Pios will travel there after this one. Sioux Falls rounds out the Clark Division at 3-9. Then the Lewis Division, Soares Valley 9-5, Mining City 8-5, Wheat City 6-7, the Spuds 5-8, Badlands 4-10, and Casper at the bottom of the Lewis Division at 3 wins and 10 losses. So we're going to take a quick break on this Platte Valley Company's pregame show. And when we come back, we'll have the Scotts Bluff Screen Printing pregame interview. See Shane and his crew at Scotts Bluff Screen Printing for all your winter, summer, fall, or spring sports needs. That's all coming up and more here on KNEB.
Imagine internet Wi-Fi that works, no matter how many people are connected or where you are in your home. Now, you don't have to imagine. The Allo Blast is here. with the latest Wi-Fi 6 technology. The Alloblast makes your internet Wi-Fi go further, faster, and more reliable. Give your Wi-Fi a blast. Visit allofiber.com/blast to switch today.
Look like a team, work like a team with professional uniforms from Ideal Linen and Uniform. Shirts, pants, coveralls, lab coats, scrubs, cook shirts, aprons, and much more. Ideal also offers flame retardant garments and feature the Ideal Connect tracking system. So when your uniforms are sent for laundry service, they will be tracked and returned professionally, cleaned and pressed. For a free quote and to see our entire line, go to ideallinen.com or stop by 506 South Beltline Highway in Scotts Bluff. Locally owned and operated for over 100 years.
Now is the time to get all your school spirit gear, and the place to get everything you need is Logos in Gearing. School spirit is what they do at Logos. Whether you're a Bulldog, a Bearcat, or a Tiger, they've got everything you need, from sweats to hats and, of course, t-shirts and sweatshirts. Need something for the entire team? Stop into Logos, and the guys will custom design it, print it, and have it ready for the game. There is no job too big or small for Logos. Logos in downtown Gearing.
KNEB 960 AM, and now on 100.3 FM.
Here on the Scotts Bluff screen printing pregame interview with head coach Antonio Garcia, coming off what is most likely the exciting win of the year, a two-run walk-off home run from Dalton Frank. How did it feel when you saw Cade McGee hit the tying home run at the bottom of the ninth and then Dalton to walk it off in that one?
Yeah, I mean, man, that was crazy. The boys battled. Again, didn't really get it done defensively. Like, we need to keep working, but two strikes, two outs in the bottom of the ninth. I mean, that's every kid's dream. And we had two guys live that dream last night and got us a win.
Yeah, I talked with that about with Dalton yesterday, having the three errors in the field, and he said it was important. Baseball is a game. You play both sides of the ball, and what does it mean to have a player and really a whole team that has the resilience and confidence to go up there at the plate even if they couldn't get it done defensively?
Yeah, same thing if they're hitting and they're having bad at-bats. And here, we tell them they got to flush and get out to the field like it never happened. Same thing over there on that side. As much as the game is like in sync, there are two very separate parts of the game. So keeping your head in the whole time is huge. And obviously Dalton didn't have the best game out there, but he flushed it when he got to the plate and had two really big hits for us.
Big win last night, clinching the series against Casper here, and Fremont losing, so gaining ground on that number one spot in the Clark division. What would it mean to get the sweep here tonight?
Oh, it'd be awesome. A lot of build momentum going into the weekend on the road, and just keep chipping away at that that lead that they have on us. And I know it's super early in the season, so we'll just keep working and keep winning games. Control what we can control. We can't control what any other teams do. So we just got to keep winning games, and hopefully we'll see ourselves at the top here soon.
Third start of the year for Caden Edwards. Excited to see him out on the mound tonight.
Yes, I am. Last week was awesome to see Caden out there and shove, and I'm excited to see him again tonight.
And last game before the trip to Hastings as they move down on that one. And again, trying to clinch the series in this one against Casper. Thanks for talking with me, Coach. Good luck tonight.
Thanks, Zach.
Exceptional medical care from renowned specialists is available to you at Morrill County Community Hospital in Bridgeport. Amber Dean, DNP, APRN, PMNHP, BC, is excited to join the Morrill County Hospital Clinic to provide behavioral health in Morrill County and its surrounding communities. To schedule an appointment with Amber, you may call 308-262-1755. Learn more about all of our specialty clinics, providers, services, and more at MorrillCountyHospital.com. Morrill County Community Hospital, exceptional care right here at home.
Is it time for a positive change? Ally Property Management and Real Estate is your ally in finding the perfect house to make a positive change in your life. I'm Megan Prouty, first-time homebuyer specialist at Ally Property Management and Real Estate. Owning your dream home may be more affordable than you think. I can guide you through the process of finding and purchasing your new home. Ally Property Management and Real Estate is proud to be in downtown Gearing and is ready to be your ally in all of your real estate needs.
8-year-old Lucas Ritz had a life jacket on and the close supervision of his mother when he was killed while swimming in their marina. A boat plugged into the shore power was leaking electricity, and Lucas swam into the energized water. His father urges every
through the peril of life. us fight. For the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
National anthem has been sung, and we are about underway here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium as the Pios try and secure the series sweep of the Casper Horseheads as Caden Edwards takes the mound. That wraps up our Platte Valley Company's pregame show. When we come back, we'll have the WNCC starting lineups, the key to the game brought to you by Team Auto Center, and, of course, opening pitch here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. You're listening to Pios Baseball on KNEB. Stay with us.
Katie, remember the day you made me the happiest man alive? I asked if you wanted to live to the fullest, to wake up every morning savoring potato olays, fluffy scrambled eggs, and breakfast burritos from Taco John's, and you said,
get your hands off my burrito.
Oh, Katie, I love when you whisper sweet nothings.
Wake up and go with bigger, bolder, better breakfast, only at Taco John's.
Drive-thru open at 6 a.m., dining room open at 8. Taco John's, with locations in Scotts Bluff, Gearing, and Bridgeport.
Details do matter, but you need to keep your eyes on the future. Let E&H handle the details. Professionals working side by side with you, offering accounting, tax planning, valuation services, and litigation support, and developing a strategy for the day you leave it all behind. Troy Hilliard, Seth Cobalt, and Lindsay Matthews are the professionals you want on your team. E&H CPAs and Management Consultants PC, 2021 Broadway, Scotts Bluff. Innovative, trusted, proven.
Good luck, Western Nebraska Pioneers, from the A. Elliott Law Office. A. Elliott Law is located at the Railway Office Plaza on the corner of Railway Street and Avenue B in Scotts Bluff, Suite C110. Needing legal counsel for criminal law, juvenile law, real estate, estate planning, probate and domestic, and family law? Call Audrey Long today for an appointment, 633-5294. A. Elliott Law supports the Western Nebraska Pioneers.
Rainbow!
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Back now at Oregon Trail Park Stadium as we await first pitch here between the Pioneers and the Casper Horseheads. You're listening to the Logos broadcast booth. Logos is your home for all your screen printing and embroidery needs. Shop the showroom or have something custom made at Logos 1344 10th Street in Garing. Zach McKinstry bringing you this one as the first pitch home from Caden Edwards misses high for ball one. The first pitch is brought to you by Papa Murphy's at 2801 Avenue B in Scotts Bluff. It's love at 425 degrees, and don't forget to register for the Papa Murphy's Text Club for a sweet deal. That one will miss the zone as well, and Caden Edwards will start behind 2-0 here on the leadoff man Eric Irato. As the 2-0 home now from the lefty, that one just misses as well. Three straight balls open up the game here. As Arado out of Northern Illinois University ahead in the count. The lefty trying to find the zone. The pitch from Edwards crosses the plate for strike one. It's time for our WNCC starting lineups. Starting lineups brought to you by Western Nebraska Community College. From diplomas to degrees, it's for me. Learn more at wncc.edu. The 3-1 turns to 3-2 as that one's fouled to the left side, and the count runs full. Eric Arado leads off at second base tonight, followed by Ryan Callahan, who will play third. Hank Dunn batting third in right field. Joe Schmidt batting cleanup, moving from his catcher position last night to first base as this 3-2 is shot foul again. Brooks Browning will bat fifth and DH tonight after playing first base last night and almost sending one out of the yard in that left center area.
Preston Joy at shortstop again, batting sixth. Landon Boyd behind the plate, batting seventh. Ricky Teal, the center fielder, batting eighth. And Luke Quick batting ninth, as that one is right down the gut for strike three. So after starting the opening batter 3-0, Caden Edwards battles back and gets the first out of the game via the strikeout, and one away in this top of the first inning brings up Ryan Callahan. Whoa, that curveball goes behind Callahan, and that one misses severely for ball one. So Kyle Pearson, head coach for the Casper Horseheads, his last game as the head coach, as Edwards brings the 1-0 home. That one crosses, and the count even at one. But Pearson is stepping down from his head coach role, will move to an assistant coach role throughout the rest of the season, as that one crosses the plate as well, the count moving to 1-2. But the coach replacing him not getting here until tomorrow, so he got to finish out this series. And this series, we've seen three kind of different lineups for the Horseheads. This breaking ball now shot out to the left side, fielded by Kellen Rutz on a dive. The throw across the diamond in time. I'll finish my story later. Kellen Rutz interrupts me with a fantastic diving play at short for out number two. Oh, my. Kellen Rutz, who played second base last night, he was 1-for-3 at the plate, had a walk, but an impressive day at second. Made a diving play just like that. Didn't have to make as far a throw, but he does it there. And an instant impact for Rutz out of Yakima Valley Community College, as he has put his impact on the series defensively. First pitch home now to Hank Dunn, misses for ball one. But Pearson, first lineup of the series was strictly a new lineup. This one now sent out into right field. And once again, my story is interrupted. This one dropped now into right field. Granholz couldn't come up with it cleanly. And reaching will be Hank Dunn, the first batter of the game to reach. And it will be an error. Defensively, JT Walden in left field tonight for the Pioneers. Eric Smelko in center. Kip Granholz out there in right, who couldn't come up with that fly ball cleanly, resulting in the runner to reach. Cade McGee moves back to third base after playing first last night. Kellen Rutz moving to short. Clay Cutter moving to second. Brian Webb going back to first after pitching last night. Oh boy, this one shot foul and through the screen into the stands for strike one. Behind the plate, we'll get our first look at Nathan Schwartz. Defensively, pinch hit last night, but only had his one at bat. He'll start tonight for the Pios. Here's the 0-1 from the lefty Edwards. This one shot up the middle, and that will get through by the diving glove of Clay Cutter, and a single will advance the runners to first and second. Once again, we'll try telling this story for the third time, but Kyle Pearson, lineup for the first day was a lot of new faces that the Pioneers didn't see in the first series. The second game was the opposite. It was a lot of those old faces coming in and playing against the Pioneers that we did see in the first series. And now for game number three, it's a mix of all those guys all coming in together. This one in there for strike one on Brooks Browning, who will bat with runners on first and second, two away here. Browning, 1-for-5 this series, has a double and an RBI, and outside of that, three strikeouts, as Edwards comes set and brings home an 0-1. This one runs inside, but the count even at one. Brooks Browning out of Regis University with the Rangers. A Casper native, went to Kelly Walsh High School and spent a season at Lynn Benton Community College in Albany, Oregon. This one now shot foul back to the screen, and the count moves to 1-2. Everybody clap your hands. Out of high school, was the player of the year and first team All-State twice at Kelly Walsh High School. As As here comes the 1-2 now from Edwards. This one called strike three. Fastball down the middle. The second strikeout of the inning gets Caden Edwards out of the jam. Two runners reach for the Horseheads, one on an error, one on a single, but nothing comes of it. They leave two stranded as we head to the bottom half. On the West Coast scoreboard, still level at zero. You're listening to Pio's Baseball on KNEB.
Marker Ag has been providing consistent quality with the best and guaranteed nutrition from Purina and Linder's Feeds. Our show feed brands have not only proven their quality through many local and national winners, but have also helped us to get to know you, the Valley's best and brightest. From those who are just starting to those who are looking to try something new, we have the experience and expertise to help you reach your goals for both commercial and show livestock. From the show ring to the sale ring, from the purple ribbons to the pastures, Marker Ag is run for you by people like you. We're located right next to El Cerrito, so stop in today so that we can get to know you better.
You know it the moment you step in the door. Perkins Restaurant and Bakery welcomes you. Join their table or use their easy Perkins to go online ordering and pick them. And right now, enjoy Perkins Strawberry Freshtival. Strawberry waffles, pancakes, and crepes. Strawberry muffins and pies and strawberry spinach salad. Summer means strawberries at Perkins. You've come to the right place. Perkins Restaurant and Bakery. Bring your appetite. They'll take care of the rest. Highway 26 and Avenue B in Scotts Bluff.
Embroidery. Scotts Bluff's screen printing and embroidery. We love embroidery. And now that we have a new machine, we love it even more. Stop in today and let Nikki show off your logo. With our new state-of-the-art machine, we can make any logo or design look amazing. And for a limited time, we are offering free setup fees for any new logo with a minimum of 12 items ordered. Stop in today and let us show off you. Come see us today at Scotts Bluff Screen Printing and Embroidery, 1813 Broadway, downtown Scotts Bluff.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Bottom of the first inning about to come your way as the Pioneers come to bat. It's Jerzen Morales on the mound for the Casper Horseheads, the Western Nebraska Community College right-handed pitcher. Has three outings on the year, a total of 12 innings of work, and has allowed five earned runs in those 12 innings, accompanied by 15 strikeouts. Pioneers will get his second crack at him this year after coming into relief in the first game of the season, going two innings in that one. And he will face a difficult Pioneers lineup, starting with Eric Smelko, who will lead it off for us here tonight. He'll be followed by Dalton Frank, who is DHing tonight after playing shortstop the last couple of games. Cade McGee will bat third and play third. JT Walden batting cleanup in left field tonight. Brian Webb at first base, batting fifth after pitching yesterday. Nathan Schwartz will bat sixth in his first start as a Pioneer. Kip Gronholz batting eighth in right field tonight. And Clay Cutter rounding out the order, batting ninth for the Pios. So we'll see this bottom of the first get started as the left-handed hitting Eric Smelko digs in and awaits the first pitch home. That one catches the outer half, strike one. And the bottom of the first is underway. Smelko on the series is 5 for 10, has three RBIs and a stolen base, 4 for 5 in game number one, as the 0-1 home is shot out to the left side and foul as the count moves to 0-2. Switch hitting Eric Smelko, batting lefty against the right-handed throwing Morales. Ahead in the count 0-2, Morales brings over his head and now comes home. The pitch, this one swung on and again shot foul out to the left side. So the count will remain where it is. Time for our Team Auto Center key to the game, home of the lifetime warranty on every new vehicle from Team Auto. The Pioneers in this one have to continue their good two-out hitting as that one's in the dirt for ball one. And they have to get it done defensively. We saw five errors for the Pioneers last night, and some errors that came around to bite them in the end. Some unearned runs for Horsehead pitching. Three total unearned runs. This one now shot out to the right side and drops into right field. It'll be a base hit. Right fielder Hank Dunn comes over and throws it into the cutoff man. But Eric Smelko will lead off this bottom of the first inning. And the Pios night at the plate with a leadoff single, moving him to 6 for 11 on the series. Scorching hot in this one as he is now hit safely in all three. And Dalton Frank steps up
to the plate. You talk about scorching hot. 2 for 3 last night. 4 runs. 2 a double. And, of course, who could forget the 2-run home run, which walked it off here in the bottom of the 9th inning, gave the Pios the 9-7 win. And Dalton Frank trying to continue that stellar night at the plate tonight. Moving up to 2 in the order. Last night was down in the 5 spot. As the first pitch home to him is swung on and now sent out to left field again. Left fielder, long way to go, and this one off the wall in the air. Pulling into third base on the throw is Smelko. And pulling into first base after a hard round is Dalton Frank. And he is scorching at the plate right now as his single puts runners on first and third with nobody out. That is a long single as that one hitting the fence in the air out underneath the scoreboard. Now a bat from Gonzaga. And Dalton Frank is on fuego. Cade McGee, who had the clutch solo home run to tie the game with 2 outs in the bottom of the 9th. A chance to drive in another run here as the first pitch, a slider off the plate for ball 1. McGee, only 1 hit on the series, and it was that solo home run. But again, it couldn't come at a better time. 3-2, 2 outs in the bottom of the 9th, nobody on. And he kept his team alive and gave Tyler Davis, then Dalton Frank, the chance to win it, which he did. So Cade McGee, equal a part of that victory as Dalton Frank. And he certainly deserves some of that recognition after his first home run of the year last night. 1-1 count now as Frank leads off of first base. Morales takes a peek and will pick off now with no throw. 2 hits already in this bottom of the first inning. The Pioneers had 2 hits entering the 7th last night. Here comes the 1-1. Dalton Frank takes off this one in the dirt and couldn't be fielded cleanly by Boyd, so there will not be a throw. And scooting into scoring position is Dalton Frank with a stolen base. Dalton Frank picking up his 4th stolen bag of the year. That is tied for the team lead with Clay Cutter and Eric Smelko. This one now off the plate. And the count goes to 3-1 on McGee. A hitter's count for the power-hitting righty. We'll see if he can keep his good night at the plate last night alive. 3-1 from Morales. Winds and delivers. This one swung on and blooped out into right field. It's going to drop for a base hit. 1 run scores. Frank's going to round and go through the stop sign, come home and score. So a 2 RBI single off the bat of Cade McGee, and 3 straight singles for the Pioneers in this bottom of the first inning. They jumped out early, the score 2-0. So I'm sure you, if you're watching on our YouTube stream, you saw the reaction of third base coach Antonio Garcia, who was nearly at the plate trying to get Dalton Frank to stop going home. And Dalton not listening, the throw cut off anyway, so Frank didn't even need to slide. And Garcia looked back to his dugout, gave him a shrug, and said, oh well, I'll take it. So 2 runs cross the plate for the Pios, and still nobody out here in this bottom of the first. First pitch home hits Walden, and another straight batter will reach. And JT Walden, the 4th straight now for the Pios to put runners on first and second with nobody out, and a 2-run lead for Western Nebraska. It's now Brian Webb who will come to the plate as a conversation between Boyd and Morales on the mound. Pioneers taking no time here, trying to jump out to this quick lead. Again, on the West Coast scoreboard, West Coast Service Solutions success. Pioneers 2 runs on 3 hits here without an out in the bottom of the first. The Horseheads went through the top of the first inning with no runs on 1 hit and a 1 Pioneers error. As the runners on first and second take their leads, the pitch home to Webb now hit out slowly to the right side. No chance at a double play. The throw to first is in time, but both the runners will scoot up, and with 1 out, 2 more Pioneers will be in scoring position.
that infield grass playing a part again.
Now the play from Aloney County.
As that ball hits slowly enough, but the grass slowing it down to the point where both runners can advance easily. No chance at the double play there, and it'll be Nathan Schwartz having an at-bat here with two in scoring position and one away. First pitch home from Morales. Drops in for a strike. Nice pitch from the righty to get ahead of Schwartz, 0-1. Schwartz pinch hitting last night as the 0-1. That one, another breaker, just doesn't drop in far enough. The count evening at one. In his pinch hit at bat, he struck out looking as the second out in the bottom of the ninth inning. As the 1-1 is now dribbled slowly towards short. It'll bring in a run for sure, and a terrible hop as that one pops over the glove of the shortstop, Preston Joy, and scores two. Sometimes when it rains, it pours at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. That seems to be the case in this bottom of the first inning, as that looked surely to be an out. Instead, Nate Schwartz, with all the luck in the world, picks up a pair of RBIs on his first Pioneers hit.
Now batting for your bios from Yakima Valley College, Kellen Russ.
I'm not sure if that looked like it might have just hit the lip on the edge of the grass out there in front of shortstop Preston Joy, and that's what caused it to bounce so high. But an unbelievably bad break for the Casper Horseheads and for shortstop Preston Joy. And for the man on the mound, too, Jerzon Morales, who with one out here, has already sacrificed four Pioneers runs. Up at the plate now is Kellen Rutz, who the count is even on him, 1-1. Rutz, 1-for-3 last night with a defensive gem at second base, and he's already flashing the leather tonight with a acrobatic diving stop at short and an equally impressive throw across the diamond to gun down Ryan Callahan as the second out in the top half. Here's the 1-1, a breaker that doesn't catch the outer half, and the count moves to 2-1. Pioneers cruising right now in this bottom of the first inning, taking that momentum that they gained in the bottom of the ninth last night and carrying it over. Rutz swings through this one, however, evens the count at 2-2 now. And we'll have to protect freshman at Yakima Valley Community College. The lefty awaits the right-handed Jerzon Morales' pitch. This one in the dirt, inside and low. And the count moves full 3-2. Runner on first base is Nate Schwartz in his first start as a Pioneer. Haven't seen him on the bases yet. But the Pioneers aggressive on the base paths this season. We'll see if Schwartz will continue that trend as this 3-2 comes home from Morales. Inside and low, gets away, so Rutz will walk down to first base with the base on balls. And moving up to second is Nate Schwartz. Still one out, and runners on first and second as Morales still trying to escape this bottom of the first inning. It'll be Kip Gronholz up at the dish as the Pios, two batters away from batting around here in this first.
Now at the plate from Gronholz,
0-for-4 in game two, or 0-for-4 in game one. He reached on an error, only time on base. And he pinch ran in game two, as that one's in there for strike one. The first series against the Casper Horseheads found success, though. 4-for-12 with three RBIs and a pair of runs for the right-handed hitting outfielder out of Southwest Minnesota State. Here comes the 0-1. That one up and in to even the count at one apiece. For Jerzon Morales at Western Nebraska Community College with the Cougars, in his what's listed as a redshirt freshman year. His 2021 year, 9 appearances for him as Gronholz swings through this one and the count moves to 1-2. Had 28.1 innings of work in which he allowed 42 runs, 35 of them earned. That's an 11.12 ERA. As Morales trying to bounce back here in summer league ball, has had a pretty good line through his first three outings on the season, but struggling early here. The 1-2 swung on and missed. Gronholz chases the high fastball and goes down on strikes for out number two.
So Clay Cutter will round out the order for the Pioneers in this bottom of the first inning. He was 1-for-4 with an RBI and a run in game two. Did not play in game one. And in the first series, he, like Granholz, was 4-for-12. Watches this one miss off the plate for ball one. Cutter tied for the team lead in stolen bases with four. Hoping he can get on base here and extend this bottom of the first inning in which the Pioneers have already plated four. The righty Morales looks to second and comes home. This one hits slowly out towards short. Going to be a tough play for Preston Joy. On the run, throws, and in time. So nine batters come to the plate for the Pioneers. Four of them cross home plate, and they lead. In the bottom of the first inning, the Pioneers on top by a score of 4-0 on the West Coast scoreboard. We head to the top of the second as Caden Edwards will trot back out. Stay with us. You're listening to Pio's Baseball on KNEB.
Be the envy of the neighborhood with the new Green Mountain Grill from High Plains Spas and Recreation. In addition to Green Mountain Grills, High Plains Spas and Recreation also has the pellets, cooking spices, rib racks, smoking shelves, covers, and other accessories, as well as replacement parts. If they don't have what you need, they could get it. Yep, get a Green Mountain Grill and be that neighbor that's always admired for the wonderful, yummy barbecue smells. High Plains Spas and Recreation, open 9 to 5, Monday through Friday, 1725 East Overland in Scotts Bluff.
Hi, we're the Goo Goo Dolls. We're fortunate that we can give our daughters everything they need to grow and learn. But not every child can focus on classes and play dates.
Nearly 13 million kids in the U.S. face hunger. That's 1 in 6. School lunch might be their only meal each day. And it's heartbreaking to imagine any child going to bed hungry. We're dreaming of a perfect day when kids can smile, play, and just be kids without worrying about where their next meal will come from. Feeding America is working to make that perfect day a reality.
Each year, the Feeding America network of food banks rescues billions of pounds of good food that would have gone to waste. That food is given to families and children in need. Being a kid should be about doing things that make an ordinary day extraordinary. Learning to play an instrument, building a sandcastle, hosting tea parties. Hunger should never be an obstacle to growing up.
You can help end childhood hunger in your community by visiting feedingamerica.org.
Brought to you by Feeding America and the Ad Council.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Back now, top of the second inning as Caden Edwards will head back out and take the bump. He will face the 6-7-8 in the order for the Casper Horseheads as they trail early in this one 4-0 after four hits in the bottom of the first inning by the Pioneers. Also a hit by pitch and a walk brought nine to the plate. And the Pioneers offense rolling early. Now hoping the defense doing the same thing as the first pitch home now to the leadoff man. Shot out towards left field. And JT Walden reading it perfectly. He'll reel it in for out number one. That'll bring up catcher Landon Boyd, who had a stellar day at batting practice. The Oklahoma commit, 2021 graduate, will get the chance to bat. And he has tons of accolades out of Parker, Colorado, and Sandra Day O'Connor High School. Sends this one out towards the right side, fielded by first baseman Webb. The flip, Edwards covers, and two quick outs for Caden Edwards. Two pitches, two outs, as we head now to the eighth batter in the order, Ricky Teal. But I've got the feeling that that won't be the last we see of Landon Boyd today. He was hot in batting practice, and he is one of the more impressive players out of high school that we have in this expedition league. As Ricky Teal up at the plate, watches this one just miss off the plate for ball one, taking all the way after two pitches and two outs out of the left-hander Caden Edwards' hand. Here comes the 1-0. This one swung on, ripped down the left field line, but it will go foul. And it'll even the count at 1-1 on the center fielder Teal out of Orange Coast College. Played in 13 games in his freshman year, the switch hitter. And in those 13 games, had a 5.28 batting average. Watches this one cross the plate. The count now moves to 1-2. Was 1-for-3 in the first game of the series.
here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. Trying to add to that line here, but the 1-2 is shot out into center field. Long way to go for center fielder Smelko. He'll get it on the run. Eric Smelko's got some range out there in center, and he makes a nice grab for a 1-2-3 inning for Caden Edwards in a low amount of pitches. The lefty heads back to the dugout, and the Pios will come to the plate in the bottom of the second inning on the West Coast scoreboard. Your Pioneers lead 4-0. Stay with us. You're listening to Pios Baseball on KNEB.
Hi, I'm Austin Dillon.
Bank at a local community bank? When you choose a local community bank, you keep money in our local economy. That money helps support local jobs, schools, and businesses. Money that helps fund a stronger and prosperous community for us all to enjoy and live in. At Platte Valley Bank, we are here to help build and support the community we love being a part of. We believe that together, we can make great things happen. Platte Valley Bank.
On 100.3 FM.
Back now for this bottom of the second inning. Eric Smelko will lead off for the second straight inning after the Pioneers brought 9 to the plate in the bottom of the first. And they come to bat with a 4-run lead here early on, trying to add to it and secure this series sweep over the Casper Horseheads. The Pios already at 9-4 on the year, 2 games back of first place in the Clark Division. Meanwhile, the Casper Horseheads at a 3-10 rate, 5.5 back of first place in the Lewis Division. As Kyle Pearson, in his last game as head coach, stepping down, going to the assistant coach position. As the first pitch to Smelko misses outside for a ball. See some questions in the chat about the weird single to Nathan Schwartz that popped over the shortstop's head. That is ruled a single. As far as JT's yesterday, I'm not so sure. You're going to have to ask the scorekeeper about that one as the count moves to 2-0. And that is going to cause Antonio Arquina behind the plate to take a nice stroll. It looked like it hit him in the shin. And I don't blame him. It's a tough spot to get hit. No pads down there. Umpires aren't wearing shin guards. But he seems to be all right. Catcher Landon Boyd gives him a break. Count now on Eric Smelko. Ahead in the count is 6-11 on the series, trying to add to that rate. Here's the 2-0 from Morales. That one off the plate, and the count moves to 3-0. Switch hitting lefty right now. We'll watch this one catch the outer half of the plate in there for a strike to move the count to 3-1. Smelko singling in the bottom of the first inning and coming around to score a run as the 3-1 home. That one now shot out into left field, or right field rather. A long way to go for right fielder. He will pull up at the track and catch it while falling down. Hank Dunn. He caught that one closer to center field than he was in right. A long route to that ball and a track meet in that outfield dirt as he had to run along the warning track and eventually come down with it in front of the Bud Light sign out there, falling down and bringing in the catch. So a nice piece of hitting by Eric Smelko, but just didn't get enough on it.
left a little too much air underneath it for Hank Dunn to run it down for a nice out number one. A nice piece of fielding by the Casper Horseheads. As Dalton Frank steps in for his second time tonight. In his last three at-bats, has the double and run, the two-run home run, which walked it off last night, and then a single and a run. He now shoots this one into left field, and keep it going, why don't you, Dalton? A nice single to the left side, his fourth straight hit for the freshman out of FAU, and he will have two singles on the day. Again, currently leads the team in home runs with three, and is tied for the team lead in stolen bases after his one in the bottom of the first inning. We'll see if he tries to take another bag here. One out, and the runner on first in Frank for Cade McGee, who had a two RBI single in the bottom of the first inning.
Now batting for your Pios from Gonzaga University, Cade McGee.
McGee awaits the first pitch from Morales. This one in the dirt gets away. Taking off for second is Frank. And Boyd, a slow reaction as no attempt to try and get Frank out. And he will scoot up to second base. And into scoring position with one out. Cade McGee, a chance for another RBI. Has two RBIs in a run. Again, all in that bottom of the first inning. Came in today with one hit, and it was the solo home run which tied it in the bottom of the ninth inning. An electric home run at Oregon Trail Park Stadium, which seemed to come out of nowhere. As Morales will come set and bring home this 1-1. That one off the plate, nice block by Boyd to keep Frank where he is. I say it seems to come out of nowhere. They asked for a meeting on the mound, and the home plate umpire said no. No, I think they asked for a new ball, and the home plate umpire said no. So he'll have to pitch with the one he just chucked in the dirt, so I assume. But again, the Cade McGee home run with 3-2 count, two away. Talked with Dalton Frank in the postgame interview last night, and he said, "Nah, we came into that bottom of the ninth, knew we were going to win." And it's that level of confidence which has pushed the Pioneers out to this 9-4 start as McGee swings and misses at this one, and the count moves to 2-2. The 2-2 home, this one off the jam piece of the bat and taking off towards first base, the throw in time. It'll allow Dalton Frank to scoot up to second. That one, a tricky one, as it did jam Cade McGee, but it shot to the right side of the mound and reaching out the outstretched glove of pitcher Jerzen Morales couldn't reel it in, and it fell. Nice base running by Dalton Frank to hold up until he saw that ball down. Now he advances up to third base. It will be out number two, but JT Walden will bat now as he shoots this one foul out to the left side for strike one. Morales pumps over the head, out of the windup, brings the 0-1 home. This one catches the outer half, no, will miss, and the count evens at 1-1 as Dalton Frank again leading off of third base, scooting up on the 4-3 ground out. Walden, four hits on the series, has been red hot as here comes the 1-1.
That breaking ball drops into the zone. They'll get the call. The count moves to 1-2 now on JT, as he'll have to hit behind in the count, 1-2. The redshirt freshman at Gonzaga, left-handed hitting outfielder, will await a 1-2 pitch. Morales shaking off a few signs and finally gets one he likes and will bring home. Check swing. Pitch upstairs. That one checked, no go. And a really nice hold by JT Walden. And he kept his bat in place to show the umpire where it was. And field umpire Paul Setticase agrees. It was ball two. The count even at two apiece now. 2-2, two outs. As the pitch home from Morales. Breaking ball sent out into left field, blooping. And the left fielder, a long way to go, will run it down after snow coning it back into his glove. That's Luke Quick. Nice play by the left fielder. And a couple of nice plays by Casper outfielders get two outs in the inning. And the Pios will leave Frank stranded at third base and wrap up this bottom of the second scoreless. We head to the top of the third on the West Coast scoreboard. Pioneers lead 4-0. You're listening to Pios Baseball on KNEB. Stay with us.
Good luck, Western Nebraska Pioneers, from the A. Elliott Law Office. A. Elliott Law is located at the Railway Office Plaza on the corner of Railway Street and Avenue B in Scotts Bluff, Suite C110. Needing legal counsel for criminal law, juvenile law, real estate, estate planning, probate and domestic, and family law? Call Audrey Long today for an appointment, 633-5294. A. Elliott Law supports the Western Nebraska Pioneers.
Rainbow!
Who is Hydrotex? Hydrotex manufactures and distributes over 300 different high-performance lubricants, including fuel conditioners, hydraulic and transmission fluid, and more. We've been helping customers improve their operations for more than 80 years with products made in the USA. We sell directly to customers and can even deliver right to your door to offer excellent service and value. Our products are made to exceedingly extend drain and grease intervals to reduce maintenance and labor costs to improve the budget. Whether you're in a factory, farm fleet, or like to go fast, Hydrotex is here to help. Visit your local Hydrotex dealer in person or online today.
B960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Top of the third inning here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium in beautiful Garing, Nebraska. Again, a gorgeous day, and on our camera view on YouTube, you can't see a cloud in the sky. A nice gentle breeze cools off the fans in attendance, as it was a hot one earlier today. Reached as high as 95, I believe, as the first pitch home from Edwards is a strike on Luke Quick. That one misses to even the count at 1-1. Quick ending that bottom of the second inning with a nice running grab in foul territory on the left side. The 1-1 to him. This one swung on and missed, and he falls behind in the count 1-2. Lefty-lefty matchup between the two as Caden Edwards stands out there. And we'll throw to the left-handed hitting Quick again. 1-2. Called strike three. Fastball on the inner half. The third strikeout of the game for Caden Edwards. Leads off this top of the third inning with an out. Caden Edwards doing pretty well, allowing one hit to this point, three strikeouts. Has 8 innings of work on the year and 12 strikeouts. 7 in his first outing in just 3 innings, and then 3 in his next 5-inning outing, as the first pitch home to the leadoff man, Eric Jurado, misses for ball 1. The 1-0 home. That one misses high as well, and the count 2-0 now on Jurado. So Caden Edwards, the lefty out of North Dakota State, is a freshman. Runs this one inside. The 6'5", 190-pound freshman from North Dakota State. That's what he's listed as out of Duluth, Minnesota. Try and fight back in the count with his 3-0, and he will find the zone for strike one. A multi-sport athlete in high school, was the quarterback at Duluth East High School and won conference offensive player of the year. As this one shot foul, and the count will run full on Irado. But impressive to have a successful pitcher on the mound that also plays quarterback. Here's the 3-2. Called strike three. It gets Eric Arado looking. Back-to-back looking strikeouts for Edwards. The same situation for Arado to lead off the game. He was ahead in the count 3-0 in his first at-bat of the game. Edwards found the zone to find a 3-1 pitch. Then it was fouled off, and then a looking strikeout to Arado. That's happened now in both at-bats. Nice battling back from the lefty Edwards. As the first pitch to the two-hole hitter Ryan Callahan is fouled away for strike one. Callahan has worn 9-12 throughout the year. Wore 12 yesterday and is back in his 9 jersey today. Confusing for us in the press box up here, but everybody gets the gist as the 1-1 pitch home from Edwards misses inside and the count moves to 2-1. Callahan out of University of Kansas awaits the 2-1. That one shot towards the Pio's dugout and into the screen as the count evens at 2-2. Left-handed batting freshman from Overland Park, Kansas awaits the 2-2. Check swing, but he went, and the tag is applied. A strike out the side inning for Caden Edwards, as once again he goes 1-2-3. And the lefties dealing in this one as we head to the bottom of the third on the West Coast scoreboard. West Coast Service Solution Success. The Pios lead 4-0 and come to bat. You're listening to Pio's Baseball on KNEB. Stay with us.
Hi, I'm Kathy Birch from Van Newkirk Real Estate. Van Newkirk Real Estate is more than a realtor. We're your helping hand of knowledge when it comes to the investment you'll make buying that perfect home. We help you discover what's right for you and your financial situation. Whether you need commercial, residential, farm property, no one will compare to the service we're about to give you. Call one of our agents today at 632-8700 for the best real estate help possible, and we're happy to show you that service is what we sell.
We can sum up McDonald's new crispy chicken sandwich in one word: crispy, but also juicy and tender. Okay, it's crispy, juicy, tender, all one word, but then also pickle. Oh, and potato bun, which is two words. Okay, we can't sum up our new crispy chicken sandwich in one word, so you'll just have to try it to understand it. Order ahead on the McDonald's app at participating McDonald's. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
FM. Morales back out to pitch this bottom of the third, in which Brian Webb will lead it off for the Pioneers after grounding out to second for the first out in the bottom of the first inning in his first AB. Played first base in game one of the series, was 1-for-4 at a run, reached on an error, and had a pair of strikeouts. Game two did not hit because he was on the mound, went 4.2 innings, allowed only one earned run on 3 hits, 1 walk, and 9 strikeouts through 4.2 innings of work. An impressive day on the bump for Brian Webb, although he did not earn the win. The winning pitcher would be Cade McGee, the same man that tied it with his home run in the bottom of the ninth inning, as the first pitch home to Webb misses off the plate for ball one. Brian Webb, a freshman at Grand Canyon University, we'll watch this one cross the plate to even the count at one apiece. From Gilbert, Arizona, where he attended Corona del Sol High School, 358 average in his 3 years of varsity baseball, also 9-3 on the bump. as that one misses inside for ball two. Had a 1.30 ERA in 75 and one-third innings pitched to help take his team to the state title game in 2019. The 2-1, that one misses off the plate. The count 3-1 now on the lefty. And in 2021 with Grand Canyon University, had 1.1 innings of work, had a strikeout, but did allow a pair of hits and a few earned runs. Here's the 3-1. Misses low and inside, ball four, and that's how this bottom of the third will get underway. Brian Webb will reach for the third time this series, first time tonight. And nobody out for Nate Schwartz, who had a little bit of luck in his first Pios at bat.
From Ohlone College, Nathan Schwartz.
A hot shot ground ball towards short that hit the lip and sailed over shortstop Preston Joy and scored two runs as a pickoff to first base. Half-hearted results in Brian Webb diving back to the bag. Schwartz out of Ohlone Junior College from San Jose, California. As the count moves to 0-1. At Lay High School in San Jose, had 23 games played his senior year, a .280 average, .322 on base, and he was classified as a great defensive catcher. Runner goes here, the throw down, nice pick, but not in time, the tag not applied. Shortstop Preston Joy is in shock. He was tossing it back to the second baseman, trying to explain that one. But Brian Webb slides in safely. The throw was one-hopped, and the pick there, that was actually Eric Arado at second base who picked it. It took him a second to field it cleanly. The tag allowed Webb to slide in safely. So Brian Webb picks up the stolen base, moves into scoring position with nobody out. Now this one fouled back off the mask of either catcher Landon Boyd or umpire Antonio Arquina. I think it was the umpire Arquina who's taken a beating back there tonight. The count 1-2 on Schwartz, who is 1-for-2 on his season with his 2 RBI single his last at bat. As here comes the 1-2 from Morales. Righty comes set, looks to second, comes home. Swung on and missed. Schwartz comes up empty. A strikeout for him is the first out in this bottom of the third inning. And Kellen Rutz will have the chance to bat after walking in his first plate appearance.
Now at bat from Yakima Valley
Lefty
College.
From Yakima Valley College out of Kennewick, Washington. 5'10", 160 pounds, what he's listed as. That one gets by Boyd, and scooting up to third base on the wild pitch is Brian Webb. As Rutz will try and pick up an RBI, looking for his first of the season. Walked and singled last night, but didn't get any further than first base after being stranded there twice. Morales shaking off some signs out of the windup with a runner on third base, but will come home with this 1-0. Rutz swinging, sending it to the right side, runner coming home, and the throw will go to first. In time, beats Rutz by a step, but he will pick up that RBI on the ground out, and the Pios expand their lead to 5-0. Kip Gronholz up at the plate trying to break out of his cold spell. 0-for-1 tonight. 0-for-4 on the series. Watches this one miss inside for ball one. In that Mining City series, he was 0-for-6 as well with a hit by pitch. So looking to get on base and take the lid off, so to speak. The 1-0, that one up and in. And the count moves to 2-0. A hitter's count for Gronholz, who started the season very hot. One of the most productive players for the Pioneers through the first couple of games. The 2-0.
That one just missing inside. And the count moves to 3-0 now on the outfielder. Righty Morales out of the windup brings home 3-0. Whoa, that runs in and hits him. Granholz flips the bat towards the dugout and will empty all his equipment before heading down to first base. Would have been ball four regardless, but it ran in and hit him. And with two outs, the Pios keep the inning alive on the hit-by-pitch. Second of the game for Morales as he hit J.T. Walden, who came around to score in the bottom of the first inning. Clay Cutter will bat now, 0-for-1 with a ground out to short as the runner goes. This one in the dirt, the throw from Boyd on a line, and that one is in time for sure and out there, as no question, Kip Granholz gunned down to wrap up this bottom of the third inning. So the Pios bring across another after Brian Webb walked, stole a base, advanced to third on a wild pitch, and Kellen Rutz drove him in on a ground out. They lead 5-0 on the West Coast scoreboard as we head to the top of the fourth inning here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. You're listening to Pios Baseball on KNEB.
Now is the time for side dress application of dry nitrogen for this year's crops. Successful producers know a complete side dress program from Westco will ensure their corn and beets have the nutrients they need to produce top yields. Westco can custom apply your side dress fertilizer with our John Deere row crop dry spreaders and save you time to accomplish other tasks during this busy spring. Let our people and equipment help you apply dry nitrogen at a rate that best fits your goals and operation. Contact a Westco location to schedule your side dress application today. Westco, service, solutions, success.
Embroidery. Scotts Bluff Screen Printing and Embroidery. We love embroidery. And now that we have a new machine, we love it even more. Stop in today and let Nikki show off your logo. With our new state-of-the-art machine, we can make any logo or design look amazing. And for a limited time, we are offering free setup fees for any new logo with a minimum of 12 items ordered. Stop in today and let us show off you. Come see us today at Scotts Bluff Screen Printing and Embroidery, 1813 Broadway, downtown Scotts Bluff.
Katie, remember the day you made me the happiest man alive? I asked if you wanted to live to the fullest, to wake up every morning savoring potato olays, fluffy scrambled eggs, and breakfast burritos from Taco John's, and you said...
Get your hands off my burrito.
Oh, Katie, I love when you whisper sweet nothings.
Wake up and go with bigger, bolder, better breakfast, only at Taco John's.
Drive through open at...
Reed Construction and Supply has been in business for over 35 years. Headquartered in Garing, Nebraska, the company provides an array of services ranging from commercial and industrial building construction to heavy highway earthwork and installation of underground utilities, as well as the Rock Pile Division service and equipment. Paul Reed Construction on 10th Street in Garing. Caden Edwards heads back out with 5 strikeouts on the day through his 3 innings of work. And his first pitch home to the 3-hole hitter, Hank Dunn, is in there as well for strike one. The lefty Edwards with 12 strikeouts through his 8 innings on the season. And only adding to that today, the 0-1 home. That one catches the outer half, and Hank Dunn falls behind 0-2. He was 0-for-4 with 3 strikeouts in game one. And so far tonight, he reached on the error, the fly ball to right field that Kip Granholz couldn't rein in. Down in the count 0-2 as Edwards delivers this fastball called strike 3. On the outer half, Caden Edwards has that pitch working. That's his 4th straight strikeout and his 5th strikeout looking tonight. Having these batters for the Casper Horseheads guessing up there, Joe Schmidt steps up with the lone Casper hit to this point, a single in the first inning. As the first pitch home misses low, ball 1. Schmidt sending it up the middle, a diving play by Clay Cutter. Could not stop that one from finding outfield grass as Edwards delivers the 1-0. That one high and away as well. And the count, a hitter's one on Joe Schmidt, the righty. Schmidt, the catcher, out of John A. Logan College, watches this one miss, and he's way ahead in the count, 3-0. Out of Washington, Missouri, Schmidt.
awaits the next pitch home. That one finds the zone, and the count moves to 3-1. That outside fastball has been getting called all day to right-handed hitters. And Caden Edwards has been pounding it. The 3-1, high and away, ball four. The first walk of the game for Caden Edwards, as he couldn't work this count back. We've seen it twice tonight, both against Eric Arado, where he was down in the count 3-0 to the leadoff man, and both times on three pitches worked back in the count to get looking strikeouts. This time the man gets on. It's one out. Schmidt on first base for Brooks Browning, the DH tonight, who has a looking strikeout in his only at-bat. First pitch home, misses off the plate, ball one. Browning playing one game this series, 1-for-5, has a double in RBI and three strikeouts, make that four after his first at-bat tonight. As the lefty comes home again, the 1-0, that one swung on and missed. Nice pitch. Browning comes up empty to even the count. The one hit for Browning was that double into the left center gap over that section 103 sign. It hit that sign in the air, Smelko leaping into it, and it was just inches away from a solo home run. This one just misses inside, and the count moves to 2-1. Schmidt not the fastest over there at first base. This one now shot slowly towards second, fielded by the second baseman Cutter. The flip to second is dropped by shortstop Kellen Rutz. That was a tough play as Cutter was turning towards the bag but moving towards the mound. And the flip backwards wasn't hard enough to be grabbed cleanly. And Rutz couldn't grab it cleanly. And runners will reach at first and second. That one will go down as an error, I'm sure. It hasn't been put up on the board either way. But regardless, one out, runners first and second as the pitch home misses outside for ball one. So Preston Joy at the plate now after lining out to left in his first AB. This one home is now shot out and off the ground and still gets away from Cutter. No chance at two, and now no chance at one, as on back-to-back plays, Clay Cutter cannot make the play. Unfortunate break for the second baseman, and that'll draw a visit to the mound from Trent Kiefer, as the first play was a chance at a double play. A slow rolling ball would have been tough, but it was dropped. And this one was a sure chance at a double play, but booted by the second baseman. So Trent Kiefer, the pitching coach, probably not only going out there for Caden Edwards, but to calm the defense down a little bit, as back-to-back errors have loaded the bases here with one away. Edwards doing his job, getting two ground balls to try and get that double play. But both times, the defense couldn't do it. Corners in for the Pioneers now. Brian Webb on the infield grass, as well as Cade McGee, as the middle infield will try and turn a double play for the third straight batter, as it's Landon Boyd at the plate, who lined out to center in his last AB. First pitch home, high and away, ball one. Still only one hit for the Horseheads to this point, as a hit here could turn the tide of the game. Pios with a 5-0 lead to this point. The pitch home, swung on, sent out to right field, but it will go foul. Strike one. Landon Boyd grounded out to first base in his last at bat, as Brian Webb moves back behind the runner at first. The lefty Edwards comes set and will come home with this 1-1. At one high as well. Ahead in the count now is the catcher Landon Boyd. The 2021 high school graduate, a catcher and third baseman out of Parker, Colorado. was at one point ranked the best position player in his state. That one, check swing misses high, and the count moves to 3-1. The check, he did not go. So a 3-1 count as Edwards in danger of walking in the first Casper run. The lefty comes set and comes home. 3-1, high and away again. Ball four brings in a run, and the Horseheads cut the deficit to now 5-1. An unearned run attributed to Caden Edwards after two errors on ground balls that could have gotten him out of the inning. Still only one out now for Ricky Teal. Lined out to center and is 1-for-3 in the series. First pitch home to him from Edwards. That one catches the outer half, strike one. Luke Quick on deck, rounding out the order for the Horseheads. Then it's the top of the order, as Edwards will try and limit the damage here in this top of the fourth inning. Pitch from the lefty. This one shot foul out to the right side. And quickly behind in the count 0-2 is Ricky Teal. Switch hitting freshman from Beckman, outfielder at Orange Coast College. Here's the 0-2. Breaking ball, swung on and missed. Gets away from Schwartz at the plate. The runner coming home, and he'll score without a throw. So a strikeout results in a run scoring on the wild pitch. And now the second unearned run will cross the plate. Unfortunate top of the fourth inning for Caden Edwards, who had been doing so well into this inning. Still doing really well, but not having the defense behind him. First pitch swinging is Luke Quick. He comes up empty for strike one. Seven strikeouts through 3.2 innings. Eleven outs have been recorded, seven of them strikeouts. This one misses low and in. The count moves to 1-1 now on the left-handed batting Luke Quick. Quick started his career at Northern Oklahoma Junior College, where he batted 389 his freshman year, 382 his sophomore year. He fouls this one back, and the count moves to 1-2. And those 2 years earned him a spot on the Oklahoma Sooners roster in 2020. He appeared in two games, had one at bat his junior year at Oklahoma. And now playing for the Casper Horseheads as this 1-2 is popped up high out of play behind the press box. And Quick will stay alive. 1-2 count, two outs, as runners on second and third for the Casper Horseheads. Edwards looks home, comes set, and will deliver this 1-2 to the plate. Breaking ball. This one shot up the middle. It's a base hit. One run scores. Smelko fields and fires home as the runner's coming home. It's on a line, but up the line. And the runner will score on the two RBI single. And Luke Quick has made this a 5-4 game. It's top of the order up for the Horseheads. We have seen some stellar offense and stellar pitching this year for the Pioneers. But the one area the Pios have been lacking is defensive. And it's showing here in this top of the fourth inning. This one dribbled up the first baseline, foul for strike one.
At bat for the Horseheads from Northern
Inning started with a looking strikeout of Hank Dunn. Joe Schmidt walked. Following that was an error on what would be double play, putting runners on first and second. Next pitch was an error on another would-be double play. As this 0-1 is shot foul again, and falling behind his leadoff man, Urado, 0-2. So that loaded the bases. Landon Boyd would come home through a walk, and the first hit of the inning is a 2-RBI single after six batters before that single. This one swung on and missed, and Arado goes down for the third time on strikes. And Edwards will strike out the sides, not before the Horseheads pick up four runs in this top of the fourth inning on the backs of a pair of errors and a pair of walks, and then the Luke Quick 2-RBI single. Bad break for Edwards on the mound, but the Pios will try and get it back here in this bottom of the fourth inning. You're listening to Pios Baseball on KNEB.
Oh, that? That's the sound of someone at Papa Murphy's using fresh ingredients to make your pizza. And this, yes, is the sweet sound of your oven timer telling you that your home-baked Papa Murphy's pizza is done. Because at Papa Murphy's, we believe that Tuesday deserves something different. Like your new way of telling your family pizza is ready.
Come and get it.
Okay. Every Tuesday, get any large pizza for just $10. Papa Murphy's. Change the way you pizza.
Fender bender? Hailstorm? Couldn't stop on the ice in time? After everyone is safe, Scott's Bluff Body and Paint should be the first call you make. There isn't a better shop in the area. Our highly skilled team is experienced at performing all auto body repair and paint jobs. Stop by anytime and speak to one of our technicians, and we'll do a full inspection to show you just how little our repair services will cost you. Our work is not complete until your car is safe and you're on the road again. Call today, Scott's Bluff Body and Paint, 225-6408.
Man, flies are annoying, aren't they? Especially when there could be 2,000 of them sitting on each cow in your herd. This can lead to stress that ultimately cuts down into your bottom line. And that's even more annoying. Using Purina Wind and Rain Mineral with fly control can help cut down the horn fly population. And it doesn't clump up, so there's no waste. Which means you can get less of that annoying fly buzz and more of that good buzz when people see how great your cattle look. Feed with greatness with Purina Wind, Rain, and Mineral with fly control. Learn more at Marker Ag at 718 21st Avenue in Scotts Bluff. Or call us at 633-1057 or like us on Facebook.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Back top, or excuse me, bottom of the fourth inning after the Horseheads have cut this to a one-run lead for the Pioneers in this bottom of the fourth inning. It looked like the Pioneers were going to run away with this one after their four runs in the bottom of the first and another run in the bottom of the third inning. But Casper crawling back into it. And the first pitch to Clay Cutter, the nine-hole hitter, is popped foul out to the right side, out of play, strike one. To this point, the Pios five hits through their three innings at the plate. This is the start of their fourth, as that one outside and away, four ball one. On top of that, a hit by pitch, two of them, and two walks as well, resulting in those five runs on the board for the Pioneers. Cutter trying to add to it as this one runs inside and misses for ball two. Clay Cutter grounding out to short to end the bottom of the first inning and was at the plate in the bottom of the third before Kip Gronholz was gunned down trying to take second. An ugly swing from Cutter at the plate there, fooled by that pitch. And a check swing goes around for strike two. Clay Cutter steps out and composes himself, steps back in with an even count, 2-2 here as Morales pumps over his head and now brings home. Off the plate low, ball three, and Clay Cutter has worked the count full here. Cutter, the freshman at Iowa Western out of Centennial, Colorado. We'll see the payoff pitch. This one dribbled up the third baseline foul, so Cutter will see another pitch. Out of high school, Cherry Creek High School in Colorado was the number 18th ranked shortstop in the state. Perfect game, preseason All-American in All-Region after 23 RBIs and a 400 average his junior year. As another payoff pitch to him, that one cuts in, strike three. Nice pitch from Morales. That one, you got to tip the cap, started in at the body of Clay Cutter and then cut out over the plate. Nice piece of pitching for out number one via the strikeout. So that is now the third strikeout of the game for Morales on the mound. And it'll bring up the top of the order and Eric Smelko, who is 1-for-2 on the day. 6-for-12 on the series. 500 average isn't too shabby. Also has 3 RBIs. A run today as well. Has the 1-0 home to him. Off the plate, and the count moves to 2-0. Hitters count for the switch hitter. Smelko out of La Mesa, California. Watches this 2-0 catch the plate, and the count moves to 2-1. Morales brings the 2-1 home now. Swung on, hit out to the right side, fielded on the backhand by the first baseman Schmidt, and tossed over to first base as covering is Morales for out number two. Two up, two down here in this bottom of the fourth inning. It's Dalton Frank at the plate again, trying to continue his current hitting streak. Has 4 hits in his last 4 at-bats. Nothing to scoff at. A double in the latter innings last night, in which he came around to score a run. Then, of course, the 2-run walk-off home run. As this one runs inside and spinning out of the way is Frank. Had a single in the bottom of the first, came around to score after stealing a base, and then another single in the bottom of the second, but was left stranded on third. Here's the 1-0 home. That one dips too low, and a hitter's count for Dalton Frank here as the count moves to 2-0. Frank up to 277 on the year after last night, 13-for-47. And has crossed the plate 17 times, which leads the team. Whoa, this one up and in. And Dalton Frank has to move out of the way yet again. And the count now 3-0. But his 17 runs on the season lead the team by a significant margin. Second closest is JT Walden with 12. This 3-0 misses ball four. So Dalton Frank will reach base on the walk, the third time he's reached tonight. And with 2 outs, the inning will stay alive for Cade McGee at the plate, who has a 2 RBI single in this one and is coming off that game-tying bottom of the ninth, 3-2, 2-out solo home run last night.
Now batting from Gonzaga University, Cade McGee.
This one a breaking ball or a cutting ball that moves inside on Cade McGee. Misses his own ball one. Morales shakes off a sign, looks to first and comes set before coming home. That one catches the outer half as the count evens at 1-1. Frank skipping his secondary and just taking off for second before pulling up, trying to distract the pitcher and catcher combo. 1-1 count on Cade McGee as the righty comes home. This one off the plate again. Landon Boyd thinking about back picking to Dalton Frank, but no throw. As Morales comes home. That one misses low and away. Ball three. Hitters count on Cade McGee. We'll see if Dalton Frank will try and take off. I doubt it after Kip Gronholz ended the inning in the bottom of the third, getting caught stealing. Landon Boyd's got a good arm behind the plate. We've seen it a couple of times, both in that bottom of the third. Both could have been ruled out. He'll take off here. This one, ball four. It doesn't matter. The walk from Cade McGee moves runners up to first and second. And back-to-back two-out walks will bring up the cleanup man, JT Walden. But Landon Boyd behind the plate almost threw out Brian Webb in the bottom of the third inning. In fact, Eric Arado thought he was out for sure. Started flipping the ball to his shortstop to throw around the infield before turning around and finding out the umpire had called him safe. And then Kip Gronholz being thrown out to end that inning. So JT Walden up at the plate with two on, two out. First pitch to him, misses high and away, ball one. On the lefty, Walden. 0 for 1 today, was hit by a pitch in the bottom of the first, then came around to score. He's also flown out on the day. As the 1-0 home, that one will catch the outer half. And the count evens at 1-1. One count on the 6-4 lefty, JT Walden, as Morales comes home again. That one too far off the plate. And again, Walden will be ahead in the count, this time 2-1. Was 1-for-3 in the first game of the series, had a pair of walks and two runs. And then in game two, 3-for-4, two RBIs. He had the solo home run and double, his first two extra base hits of the year, and was a triple away from the cycle in that one. As here comes the 2-1, this one, an ugly check swing, goes around, and the count moves to 2-2. As the lights come on here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium, this is probably the earliest we've seen the lights come on, as the sun's still setting, and a good amount of light naturally here at the stadium. 2-2 count, two away, two on base for the Pios, as the pitch comes home to JT Walden, way outside, and gets by Boyd. He was going to throw to second base to try and get McGee, but no one covering the bag as they got a candy hop off the backstop. And the Pios move into scoring position on the wild pitch, full count now. Brian Webb stands in the on-deck circle, JT Walden at the plate. With a 3-2 count, two away, two in scoring position. The pitch home, too high, ball four. Two quick outs on the mound for Jerzen Morales after the looking strikeout of Clay Cutter and the 3-1 ground out of Eric Smelko. Since then, it's been three straight walks. The bases loaded with two outs and a visit to the mound. Has some action going on in the Horsehead bullpen. We'll see if this is the end of the day for Morales. Pearson will leave the mound, and Morales will stay there. The righty, given the green light from his coach to stay in and try and get out of this jam that he's put himself into. Brian Webb on the night walked and scored and has grounded out. The left-handed hitting Brian Webb will try and drive in some runs here. Has five RBIs on the season in 27 at-bats, six hits and six runs for Webb. That one off the plate, ball one. Boyd had to go a long way to stop that one from going to the backstop, and Dalton Frank has got to be on his toes after seeing some wild pitches from Morales already in this one. Out of the windup, Morales comes home with this 1-0. This one now shot out into left field. It's going to find outfield grass, and two runs are going to score. Rounding second and coming into third, and getting away from his coach is JT Walden. Coming home, the throw on a line, not in time. A bases-clearing double for Brian Webb, and the Pios jump out in front with some two-out hitting. They lead 8-4. So two quick outs for Morales, and head coach back out to the mound. This time Morales won't talk his way out of it. He'll head back to the dugout, but he goes back to the dugout one batter too late. Pitching change now here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. They are going to rule it an E7 after left fielder Luke Quick couldn't field it cleanly on the throw in. As the new pitcher into the game for the Casper Horseheads is number 15, Andrew Hansen. Taking a look at Hansen's stats on the year. Has 5 games played, 8.2 innings pitched, 8 hits allowed, 13 runs, 6 of them earned, 8 walks and 8 strikeouts. It all combines for a 6.23 ERA. And Morales' day will end after allowing 8 runs through the first 4 innings. And Pio's lighting him up today. Hansen. The righty standing 6'160" out of Neosho County Junior College. First pitch home now is swung on and missed by Nate Schwartz. 4 strike 1. Schwartz on the night has the 2 RBI single and strikeout. And the 0-1 to him is swung on and missed. Schwartz quickly behind in the count. From Aurora, Colorado, the righty comes home with the 0-2, swung on and missed, and enters into the game, throws 3 pitches, all of them swung at by Schwartz, but he goes up and strikes out. His second strikeout of the game is out number 3 in this bottom of the fourth inning. But after 4 batters reach with 2 outs, 3 runs cross the plate for the Pios, and they answer the 4-run top half with 3 of their own. We head to the fifth inning. Pioneers out on top on the West Coast scoreboard by a score of 8-4. You're listening to Pios Baseball on KNEB. Stay with us.
Did you know Ideal Linen and Uniform is also a full-service janitorial supply provider? You don't need to worry about finding your janitorial supplies. Ideal will keep your business stocked, saving you time and money. Ideal Linen and Uniform provides quality cleaning and industrial products. Mops, soap, air freshening system, paper products, custom logo maps, cleaning supplies, even signage, and more. Call for a free quote. Ideal Linen and Uniform, locally owned and operated since 1907. 506 South Beltline, Scotts Bluff. Online at ideal-linen.com or call 632-7197.
Now is the time to get all your school spirit gear, and the place to get everything you need is Logos in Gearing. School spirit is what they do at Logos. Whether you're a Bulldog, a Bearcat, or a Tiger, they've got everything you need, from sweats to hats and, of course, T-shirts and sweatshirts. Need something for the entire team? Stop into Logos, and the guys will custom design it, print it, and have it ready for the game. There is no job too big or small for Logos. Logos in downtown Gearing.
Some things have changed, some things haven't. The same great food, breakfast, lunch, or dinner is still being served at Perkins, along with yummy muffins, cookies, and pies. When you're in, be sure to ask your server how to sign up for Perkins eClub, where you can get Perkins coupons and special promotions sent to your email. You can sign up online or in your Perkins in Scotts Bluff. Eat in or call in, or we will have it ready for you to pick up. Homestyle cooking any way you slice it. Perkins Restaurant and Bakery, Scotts Bluff.
KNEB 960 AM, and now on 100.3 FM.
Caden Edwards heads back out for the top of the fifth inning with 8 strikeouts on his docket on the day. First pitch home runs up and in on Ryan Callahan for ball 1. He's got 1 of those strikeouts. His other at bat was a 6-3 ground out in which Kellen Rutz made a diving play. So a tough night at the dish for Callahan, but he gets ahead here 2-0 after the first two pitches miss from Edwards. Here's the 2-0 home. This one now hits slowly out towards short. Rutz again. Fields on the run, throws, and not in time. Ryan Callahan busting it out of the box, and he'll beat the infield single for the leadoff man to reach. That's a tough play from Rutz as he's playing deep, close to the edge of the outfield grass, if not on the edge of the outfield grass, and has to go a long way to field that one before getting that throw off. Callahan's speed beating him to the bag. So the freshman who redshirted in 2021 stands on first base as the pitch home to Hank Dunn misses way outside for ball number one. Dunn, the Yak at Yakima Valley College, freshman from Lincoln County High School in Eureka, Montana. Pitch home from Edwards. That one will cross the zone, evening the count at one apiece. On the three-hole hitter, 0 for 4 with three strikeouts in game one. So far today, he's struck out once looking to lead off the top of the fourth, and then reached on an error in the first. Edwards shoots this one foul out of play, and the count moving to 1-2. Right-handed hitter, Hank Dunn, will step out before this 1-2. Lefty Caden Edwards stares in. Runner on first base is Ryan Callahan. As with 1-2, nobody out, Edwards will come home. This one dribbled out towards short. Rutz fields on a slide. Throws to second for one. The throw to first, not in time. As legging out the fielder's choice is Hank Dunn to break up the double play. But a nice play at short by Kellen Rutz as he dropped to a knee to get at least the one there. One out and a switch at first base as Callahan heads back to the dugout and Hank Dunn reaches. Joe Schmidt at the plate, has singled and walked in his two plate appearances tonight, also scored a run. That one misses outside for ball one. Schmidt only 7 games played for the Vols of John A. Logan College in the 2021 season. Swings and misses at this one, and the count even at 1-1. Went to Borgia High School in Washington, Missouri, as the 1-1 home from Edwards. Runner takes off for second. This one low and inside. The throw from Schwartz on a line, but not in time. And sliding in safely with the stolen base is Hank Dunn. So aggressiveness on the base path by both teams tonight. As a runner moves into scoring position for the Horseheads, 2-1 count home from Caden Edwards. That one fouled out of play. The count moves to 2-2. That's going to get me all season. We got a Carson Ohl, Caden Edwards, Cade McGee. I'm bound to mix some of those names up. But we'll get better as it moves on. Caden Edwards at the plate, 2-2. That one low, and the count will run full. 3-2 now on Schmidt, the cleanup man, with one out and the runner on second base in Hank Dunn. On the West Coast scoreboard, the Horseheads 4 runs on 3 hits, 1 errors. The Pios 8 runs on 6 hits and 3 errors. Edwards trying to get this big out here, swung on, fouled back to the screen, and the 3-2 will be a foul ball, and Schmidt will stay alive. Full count pitch home, shot foul again. And we'll have another 3-2 to come. Looking through the chat in our YouTube stream. Thanks for all those watching. Once again, loving the conversation, the back and forth of being able to stream live on YouTube. As the 3-2 home. This one swung on and missed. Schmidt does not foul it. He comes up empty. The throw down to first is in time. And that will secure the strikeout, but the runner will move up to third base. And that'll bring a visit to the mound from Antonio Garcia. Kane Edwards looking at him like he doesn't want to leave the game. Firmly planted in the mound. And he'll have a conversation out there. Get some fist bumps from his infield. And Antonio Garcia waves away the arm that was going to come in out of the bullpen. So Caden Edwards will try and get into this, wrap up this top of the fifth inning on his own. He has 10 strikeouts on the night, looking for number 11 to leave that runner stranded on third base as Brooks Browning steps in and fouls this one back for strike one. No one count now as Edwards, the lefty, comes set, looks home, and will deliver to the DH. That one off the plate to even the count at 1-1. Inning started with the single from Ryan Callahan. Fielder's choice from Hank Dunn allowed Dunn to reach. He stole second base, advanced to third on the strikeout wild pitch. And Browning swings through this one. The count 1-2 is where we're at. 1-2 count, two outs, runner on third base. In this top of the fifth inning, in which the Pios lead by 4. Edwards comes set and will now come home. 1-2. This one shot out towards short. Tried to be fielded on the dive by Kellen Rutz, but he can't bring it in. And that will fall into outfield grass for an RBI single from Brooks Browning. Once again, that's a tough play for the shortstop to make, but that's not a hard hit ball. And the Casper Horseheads capitalizing on baseballs that somehow find their way into the outfield. On to pitch now. It looks like it'll be Teddy Brockstrom to replace Caden Edwards, who exits with a fantastic line. The 5 runs that cross the plate don't speak for the lefty out of North Dakota State as he steps off the mound wanting to end that inning. But we'll get an applause from the Pios faithful. And fist bumps from his teammates. Brockstrom in the lefty on the pitch. We'll need one out to get out of this top of the fifth. As the score now 8-5. The Pios still lead. Once again, the defense for the Pioneers has been the only tough spot for Western Nebraska. Everywhere else, they seem to be competing or in the top of their categories. At the plate, they're pouring in runs, seeing lots of strikeouts on the mound. Entering into this series, they led the league in strikeouts with 5 more than the second place team, the Soares Valley Sabredogs. Speaking of the Expedition League, let's take a look around the league. Scores from around the league. The Fremont Moo on top of the Hastings Sidebusters 6-4 in the bottom of the eighth at Duncan Field. The Pier Trappers trailing the Sioux Falls Sunfish 7-6 in that one, top of the eighth. Top of the fifth at Wolf Field in Caldwell, Idaho, as the Canyon County Spuds scoreless with the Mining City Tommyknockers. Sioux Falls losing four straight to the Trappers. Trying to change that there. And the Fremont Moo trying to take down the Sodbusters after they beat them for the second time on the year. As Brockstrom is ready to roll here. First pitch home now to Preston Joy is swung on and missed for strike one. Teddy Brockstrom, the lefty, is out of St. Paul, Minnesota, another Southwest Minnesota State athlete on this squad. Runner takes off as this one shot down the third baseline. Foul. Would have surely scored the runner in Brooks Browning, who had quite the head start, good jump against the lefty. But instead, it will sail foul. Everyone will have to head back, and they'll try again. I have tons of information on Teddy Brockstrom, who's been around the league for a while. Graduated high school in 2016. Graduate of Roseville High School, where he lettered in baseball and football. As the 0-1, that one gets by Schwartz, a curveball that missed high, and advancing up to second base is Browning. And the count even at 1-1. But Teddy Brockstrom in 2018 was on the inaugural team with the Pioneers, which won the Expedition League Championship, played on the Pioneers in 2019 as well, the team that lost in the championship, as this one shot foul. The count moves to 1-2. And in 2020, decided to stay closer to home in the Northwoods League with the Wilmar Stingers before returning to the Pioneers here in 2021. And Teddy Brockstrom tries to get out of this inning with this 1-2. He looks to second, now looks home and delivers. Breaking ball, ooh, just missed off the outer half. And the count evens at 2-2. But maybe Brockstrom's the secret to success for the Pioneers. After the 2020 season in which he played in the Northwoods League, the Pioneers had their worst season in the league so far in the COVID season with less teams in the league. But both the teams that Brockstrom has been on went to the championship, and you can see why, as that 12-6 breaker drops into the zone, and a swing and a miss from Preston Joy wraps up this top of the fifth. We head to the bottom half. The Pioneers lead 8-5, but that fifth run coming on an RBI single from Brooks Browning, which chased the starter, Caden Edwards. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Pio's coming to bat. You're listening to Pioneers Baseball on KNEV.
Hey, Scott's Bluff and Gehring. Dave Ramsey here. Think a credit card's safer to use than a debit card? Well, it's not. With credit cards, you incur debt instead of using money that you already have. With a First State Bank debit card that is linked directly to your First State Bank checking account, you avoid debt since the money is immediately withdrawn from your account. You also avoid interest, late fees, over-the-limit fees, or annual fees. Talk with my friends at First State Bank today. First State Bank, member FDIC.
I struggled with symptoms like frequent gas and stomach pain for years.
I was bloated all the time with daily diarrhea.
At first, I thought it was what I was eating.
I kept thinking it was stomach issues.
So I did my research and talked to my doctor, and we finally uncovered the truth.
It was actually EPI. Exocrine pancreatic insufficiency, or EPI, is a condition where your pancreas is unable to help break down your food.
It can lead to symptoms like diarrhea, gas, bloating, stomach pain, unexplained weight loss, and oily stools.
And EPI symptoms can be confused with those of other common digestive conditions, like irritable bowel syndrome, Crohn's, and celiac disease.
So getting to the right diagnosis meant being more open with my doctor about the severity of my symptoms and how often they were happening.
But there's good news. EPI is manageable, so don't wait any longer. Use the symptom checker at identifyepi.com and schedule a visit or call with your doctor to ask, Could I have EPI?
Sponsored by AbbVie.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Pio's coming to bat here in the bottom of the fifth inning with an 8-5 lead. It's the 7-8-9 in the order, starting with shortstop Kellen Rutz, who is walked and grounded out but picked up an RBI in two at-bats tonight. Two plate appearances, I should say, as the lefty will get things going against Andrew Hansen, who heads back out to take the mound again.
For the Pioneers from Yakima Valley College, Kellen Rutz.
First pitch to Rutz, shot foul to the left side, and that is strike one. Hansen again out of Neosho County Community College from Aurora, Colorado. Freshman right-handed pitcher. As Rutz's 0-1 just misses, and the count goes to 1-1. The lefty trying to get his Pioneers going. They scraped across three runs in the bottom half of the fourth inning as this one's fouled away and scares a pigeon, which has been sitting on the foul net. That pigeon will now head to the opposite side of the foul net, and the count will move to 1-2. Kellen Rutz swings at this one and bloops it out into left field. The left fielder, Luke Quick, will watch this one carry a little bit and reel it in for out number one. Kip Gronholz will step up. The eight-hole hitter has had a tough night so far tonight. He struck out in his first at-bat, was hit by a pitch in his second plate appearance, but was caught stealing to end that bottom of the third. He's got an error in right field defensively tonight, but trying to turn things around here as he's first pitch swinging, comes up empty for strike one. Here's the 0-1 home. This one now shot up the middle, attempted bare hand by the pitcher, and that one goes into center field. It'll be a base hit, as it seemed like there could have been a play made by one of the middle infielders, shortstop Preston Joyer, second baseman Eric Arado, but a miscommunication, and both of them kind of pull up and watch that ball go into center field. So Kip Gronholz picks up his first single in a while. I'm sure he's happy to stand on first base with one out and the nine-hole hitter Clay Cutter at the dish.
Clay Cutter.
This one chopped foul for strike one. Andrew Hansen started his season with the Casper Horseheads in the win against the Pioneers, went 1.2 innings, allowed one earned run on one hit, though he had four walks. As that one misses off the plate, the count even at 1-1. Against the Tommyknockers, he went two innings, allowing no earned runs, no hits, and one walk. Worst performance was in the 23-1 loss to the Saberdogs, as this one's blocked behind the plate by Landon Boyd, and the count moves to 2-1. Through one inning, allowed six runs, two of them earned on five hits, one strikeout. This one gets away from Boyd after it short hops him and sails over his head. Moving up to second base on the wild pitch is Kip Gronholz. And with one out, the Pios have a runner in scoring position and a 3-1 count on Clay Cutter, who was 1-for-4 with an RBI and a run in game two, was 4-for-12 with a run and a pair of RBIs in the first series against Casper. And on the season for Clay Cutter, he's been having a good season with a 262 rate. Sends this one out into left field. It's going to drop for at least a base hit. And the center fielder can't cut it off cleanly. Cutter digging for second base, and he'll pull in with an RBI double to score the run. And the Pios lead 9-5. Well, Clay Cutter has some family in attendance here, so I've been told. And putting on for him there, as that was a big RBI double. And the Pios continue to put runs up on the scoreboard.
From St. Mary's College.
Entering into the series, the Casper Horseheads allowing 13 runs a game. And all three games, the Pios have put up nine, as this one catches the strike zone on Eric Smelko for strike one. In losses this season entering into the series, Casper averaging 16 runs against per game. As the 0-1 to Smelko misses low, Cutter thought it was going to skid away to the backstop and started towards third, but held up and headed back to the second base bag. It's a 1-1 count with one out. Eric Smelko, the switch hitter at the plate, batting lefty again. And we'll watch this 1-1 and bloop it into the infield grass. Long way to go for the third baseman who bare hands and throws, but it's not in time as Smelko beats it out down the line. And advancing up to third is Clay Cutter. Second hit of the day for Eric Smelko, his seventh of the series, as he has been red hot as he stands on first base. And that would have been a fantastic play from Ryan Callahan, who had to go a long way to get to that ball, then fielded it barehanded. But the speedy Smelko beating it out, and runners on the corners with one out here for the Pios. It's Dalton Frank at the plate, the one guy Casper does not want, as that one catches the zone for strike one. Again, had in his last five plate appearances, has four hits, a double, a home run, two singles, and the walk as the 0-1 drops and misses inside to even the count at 1-1. Has two runs on the day today. And on the series, that's seven runs for Dalton Frank. The 1-1 to him, the runner goes, but this one fouled out of play for strike two. So 27 runs the Pios have put on the board against Casper this series to this point, and seven of them scored by Dalton Frank. And he also has three RBIs in the series, so 10 runs accredited to Dalton. A chance to score another, one out, runners on the corners, and a 1-2 pitch from Andrew Hansen. This one swung on and missed. And Dalton Frank will head back to the dugout. His first strikeout of the night will be out number two here in this bottom of the fifth. And it will bring up Cade McGee, who will try and pick him up. So after this series, the Pioneers heading to Hastings to take on the Sodbusters in the first matchup between those two this year. As Cade McGee tries to expand that lead for the Pioneers and help secure a Pio sweep. This one off the plate, ball one. Inning started with a fly out from Kellen Rutz, followed by a single from Kip Gronholz, who came around to score on the RBI double from Clay Cutter. Eric Smelko with a single as this one sails high for ball two. Followed by the Dalton Frank strikeout. Cade McGee ahead in the count 2-0 now with two outs, runners on the corners. Smelko still at first base. So I know he has thoughts of stealing that second base bag. He won't do it here. This one misses low and in for ball three. Count. Hansen takes a peek and comes home. The 3-0 shot foul back to the screen as the count moves to 3-1. And again, that pigeon stays still. You must love that wire that's holding up the foul netting as he is just hanging out up there. Home, this one high as Smelko was taken off, but it is ball four and it'll load the bases. So again, with two outs, the Pios have the bases loaded. We'll see if they can come through for the second time after the bases being loaded on the three straight walks in the bottom of the fourth inning, and the three RBI double from Brian Webb brought all of them home. This time it's JT Walden who will bat after he has scored two runs on the night, one on a hit by pitch, one on a walk. Other than that, he's flown out. But has four hits on the series, three of them coming last night. First pitch to him misses low for ball one. Was a triple away from the cycle last night. Two RBIs, a solo home run, a double. As the lefty awaits the pitch from Andrew Hansen, the 1-0. That one misses low and gets away. Coming home is Dalton Frank. Clay Cutter. Cutter will score. And that is run number 10 for the Pioneers as everybody moves up 90 feet. And they score on the wild pitch. Advancing to third is Smelko, to second is Cade McGee, and a 2-0 count now to JT Walden. Still with the runners in scoring position. This one missing inside and low, and he'll have a 3-0 count. We'll see if he has the green light. On deck is Brian Webb, who had that bases clearing double his last AB. No, there is action in the Casper Horseheads bullpen as the 3-0 swung on and fouled towards the Horsehead dugout. Pitcher warming up, hiding behind the newly installed playground to the right of the press box, right behind the Horsehead dugout. Some kids over there enjoying it right now, as I'm sure they have a nice view from their little perch. 3-1 count from Andrew Hansen to JT Walden. This one is shot foul. It was a breaking ball. Walden out in front of. But it gets underneath it and sends it out of play. And so the count will be full. Open base at first with runners on second and third. A full count to JT Walden as Hansen will try and get out of this inning. Righty comes set, comes home. Here's the pitch, too high, ball four. That one bouncing off the backstop and coming in to score is Eric Smelko on the second wild pitch of the at-bat. As advancing up to first base is JT Walden with his second walk of the game. Tons of wild pitches for the Horseheads here as runners on the corners. And Brian Webb up at the plate again. Another lefty in this Pio's lineup. It goes switch hitter in Eric Smelko to righty, righty, lefty, lefty. As this one is now out into right field, it's another base hit for Brian Webb. And his single brings home another run for the Pioneers. Again, when it rains, it pours at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. An RBI off the bat of the first baseman. His fourth RBI of the game scores Cade McGee. And runners on the corners again with two outs as the line keeps moving for the Western Nebraska Pioneers. First pitch swinging is now popped up on the infield. A long way to go for the first baseman who started going back, but Schmidt eventually runs it down for out number three. And that will wrap up this bottom of the fifth inning. So once again, Casper scores in the top half, and the Pios not having it, putting up four in the bottom of the fifth. They now lead 12-5 in this one on the West Coast scoreboard. We head to the top of the sixth inning as the Pioneers head back out to the field. You're listening to Pios Baseball on KNEB.
Why bank at a local community bank? When you choose a local community bank, you keep money in our local economy. That money helps support local jobs, schools, and businesses. Money that helps fund a stronger and prosperous community for us all to enjoy and live in. At Platte Valley Bank, we are here to help build and support the community we love being a part of. We believe that together, we can make great things happen. Platte Valley Bank.
Who is Hydrotex? Hydrotex manufactures and distributes over 300 different high-performance lubricants, including fuel conditioners, hydraulic and transmission fluid, and more. We've been helping customers improve their operations for more than 80 years with products made in the USA. We sell directly to customers and can even deliver right to your door to offer excellent service and value. Our products are made to exceedingly extend drain and grease intervals to reduce maintenance and labor costs to improve the budget. Whether you're in a factory, farm fleet, or like to go fast, Hydrotex is here to help. Visit your local Hydrotex dealer in person or online today.
rates are near historic lows, and now is an ideal time to refinance your home at a lower rate. Refinancing gives you options to improve your home, consolidate debt, or lower your monthly payments. We don't know how long these low rates will last or when they will be this low again. So call Jennifer today at 308-220-0503 for a free refinance consultation.
Castle & Cook Mortgage, LLC, NMLS ID 1251. Jennifer Brand Yurdialis, loan originator, NMLS ID 1059626. This is not a commitment to make a loan. Not all who apply will qualify. Equal housing lender.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
West Nebraska Pioneers have put up 30 runs against the Horseheads this series. The Horseheads only plating 14 to this point. As the Pioneers lead by 7 here in this top of the 6th inning, Teddy Brockstrom returns to the game after getting the one out he needed in the bottom of the 5th. First pitch home is a strike on Landon Boyd. He struck out Preston Joy in the only batter he faced in the bottom half after replacing starter Caden Edwards, who finished the day with double-digit strikeouts. Now a conversation on the mound between the battery duo going over some signs as Boyd at the plate. 0-for-1 with a ground out. He walked and scored in that fourth inning. Boyd airing out some grievances with home plate umpire Antonio Arquina. But the next pitch from Brockstrom sails too high. Couldn't get on top of the curveball, and the count even at 1-1 on the lefty from Southwest Minnesota State. Here's the 1-1. Swung on and missed. Fastball high and away that Boyd couldn't reach, and he falls behind 1-2. Landon Boyd behind in the count as Teddy Brockstrom tries to put him away. The lefty comes set and now comes home. 1-2 just misses inside, evening the count. Boyd is 3-for-20 on the season entering into today. He's now, I guess, 3-for-21. A 150 average as this one's now shot out towards short. Diving is Rutz, but it gets behind his glove and into left field for a base hit. Make that 4-for-22 as the leadoff man, Landon Boyd, gets on with a leadoff single. That is the 5th hit of the day for the Horseheads.
Now at bat from Orange Coast College, Ricky Teal.
As the first pitch home is now shot out to the same spot, and it's going to be the same result. No, Rutz dives and keeps it from getting to left fielder JT Walden. But it will be the same result. A single, back-to-back singles, put runners on first and second now, with nobody out in this top of the sixth, as the Horseheads aren't giving up on this one. They're trying to crawl back into this game 3 at Oregon Trail Park Stadium after dropping game number 1 by a score of 9-2, the game in which Carson Ohl got the win. And, of course, last night the 9-7 loss in a heartbreaker for the Horseheads, but a thrilling victory for the Pioneers down to their final strike, a game-tying home run off the bat of Cade McGee, and then the two-run home run from Dalton Frank as the 1-0 from Teddy Brockstrom runs up and in for ball 2. Of course, if you want to rewatch that, that's on the YouTube. And I cut up the 2 home runs. Those are on my Twitter, at McKinstryZach, if you want to follow. As the 2-0 count now from the lefty Brockstrom facing the left-handed hitting Luke Quick. This one swung on, fouled back, and the count at 2-1. 10 hits for the Pioneers in this one. 4 errors as well, as the Horseheads 5 runs on 5 hits and 1 error. Two-one count. Brockstrom looks to second, and now comes home. That one just misses on the outside half, and the count 3-1. Still nobody out, runners on first and second, and Brockstrom in danger of walking the bases loaded here. 3-1 count. He comes home. This one swung on and missed. Coming up empty is Quick, and the count goes full. Quick, 1-for-2 on the day, the 2-RBI single in the fourth. To lefty Brockstrom. Full count, payoff pitch to Quick. It comes home. Ooh, just misses inside. Ball four to load the bases. Fans did not like it, but this inning opens up with the bases loaded for the Casper Horseheads. In the top of the order coming up to the plate, starting with Eric Arado, who was 0-for-3 in his first game played in the series, had an RBI and a stolen base. Tonight, 0-for-3 with 3 strikeouts as he tries to avoid the golden sombrero.
Now at bat from Northern Illinois University, Eric Arado.
First pitch home from Brockstrom and swung on, popped foul out of play to the left side for strike one. You got good arms in the outfield for the Pioneers. Eric Smelko in center, JT Walden in left, and Kip Gronholz in right. All of them fairly good range as well. As the 0-1 home is swung on and sent out to the outfield on a line. Long way to go for Eric Smelko, who fields this one at the warning track and will pull it in for the out. It will drive in a run, but nothing more as the sac fly makes the score 12-6. A big out number one for Teddy Brockstrom in, but it puts runners on the corners with one out.
Now at bat from the University of Kansas, Ryan Callahan.
Ryan Callahan at the plate now. He's 1-for-3 on the day. Sends this one towards third. Chance at a double play. McGee to second for one, but on the transfer. They can't get the double play, and another run will score. And that will be ruled a fielder's choice. That's an FC 5-4 with an RBI. As Callahan will reach base, heading back to the dugout is Luke Quick. And the run coming home to score is Ricky Teal. And once again, defense can't turn that double play. Showing bunt is Hank Dunn. He pulls back, and that one finds the zone anyway as the count moves to 0-1. Five-run game as Casper has plated 7 in their last 3 innings. Pio's plating 8 in their last 3 innings. And it has been a back-and-forth offensive performance in this one after some defensive misplays by the Pioneers. Again, 5 errors last night for the Pios and 4 tonight. That's 9. Runner goes here. This one a curveball way off the plate. No chance at a throw from Schwartz as the time home from Teddy Brockstrom combined with the off-speed pitch means that Callahan advances to second on the stolen bag. 2-1 count on Hank Dunn now with 2 outs here in this top of the 6th inning. The lefty Brockstrom comes home. This one missed the zone. Not sure where, but the count 3-1 now as Brockstrom will have to fight back. 3-1 count, 2 away. Here's the pitch home. That one finds the zone. And so the count. Full, 3-2, 2 outs. The strike zone not taking its rectangular shape tonight. Probably looks pretty weird. As the count is 3-2, 2 outs. At the plate, it's Hank Dunn trying to keep this top of the 6th alive, in which Casper has already scored 2. Rockstrom looks to second, comes home. 3-2 is shot out towards short. Rutz dives and fields it. The throw across the diamond. In time, Rutz does it again. The shortstop, Kellen Rutz, snags that one on a diving effort as blocking his view at second base was Callahan. He still got a glove on it and made the throw for out number three. The Casper Horseheads plate two more, cut the deficit to five as the Pios come to bat here in the bottom of the sixth inning. You're listening to Pios Baseball on KNEB.
A thunderstorm or tornado doesn't have to last long to wreak havoc. Once the storm is passed, it doesn't mean the danger has. There could be a variety of deadly hazards left by the storm, like a downed power line. There's no way to tell if a power line is energized and potentially deadly. A downed power line does not have to be arcing or smoking to kill you. Stay away from it. Keep others away and call 911. For more information on how to be safe during and after severe weather, go to safeelectricity.org. Brought to you by Chimney Rock and Roosevelt Public Power Districts.
Your Touchstone Energy Partners.
Imagine internet Wi-Fi that works, no matter how many people are connected or where you are in your home. Now, you don't have to imagine. The Allo Blast is here. With the latest Wi-Fi 6 technology, the Allo Blast makes your internet Wi-Fi go further, faster, and more reliable. Give your Wi-Fi a blast. Visit allofiber.com/blast to switch today.
Landlords, is it time for a positive change? Ally Property Management and Real Estate can help you make that positive change in your life. Our goal at Ally is simple, to help you make your income property work for you. We accomplish this by providing professional full-service property management, allowing you to focus on your own personal ventures. Ally Property Management and Real Estate is proud to be in downtown Gearing and is ready to be your ally in all your real estate needs.
KNEB 960 AM, and now on 100.3 FM.
So after the stellar defensive play by shortstop Kellen Rutz, he'll lead it off here in this bottom of the sixth inning, and he'll face a new arm in Will Clare, the Casper native from Mount Hood Junior College. The freshman will pitch here for the Horseheads. On the West Coast scoreboard right now, the Pioneers leading the Horseheads by a score of 12-7 as they look to sweep in this one. A word from Wells Fargo. For more than 125 years, Wells Fargo Advisors has created wealth management and investment strategies aimed at achieving our clients' personal financial goals. Call Ryan Windhorst at 632-7561. Together, we'll go far. The left-handed hitting Rutz steps up to the plate, has walked, has an RBI ground out and a fly out in his three plate appearances today. That's an 0-for-2 line as the first pitch to him is popped foul out of play for strike one. Was 1-for-3 last night, had his first hit with the Pioneers in the bottom of the eighth inning. As the count now even at 1-1. Will Clare brings the 1-1 home. This one in off speed on the outer half and a nice pitch and nice location moves the count now to 1-2. Here comes the 1-2 now from the righty. That one in the dirt low. The count evens up at 2-2. Will Clare brings this one home, and Rutz stays alive after he fouls this one off the end of the bat. And the count remains at 2-2. Will Clare, a pitcher and outfielder in high school at Natrona County High School in Wyoming. This breaking ball is now shot out to the left side. It will go foul at the last second as it cuts to the left of the third base bag with Rutz's speed. From his left-handed batting position, he certainly would have beat that out had it stayed fair, but instead he will come back up to the plate in another 2-2 count. We've seen some good at-bats at the plate from Pioneers this season. They've been working counts from pitchers and fouling off in two strike counts. Here's another 2-2 as this one is shot towards short, fielded by Preston Joy, as on the run he fires, and a close play at first, but the throw beats him by about half a step. So Rutz will go down as out number one in this bottom of the sixth inning, as up at the plate is Kip Gronholz, who singled and scored in his last at bat. I'm sure a sigh of relief for Kip after going hitless in his last couple series. That one missing outside for ball one. Again, was 4-for-12 with 3 RBIs, 2 runs in his first series against Casper, and helped lead the way through that first and second series for the Pioneers offensively, as the 1-1 home from Clare. That one a curveball dropping too low, and Gronholz ahead in the count. Righty takes a long look at his bat before stepping back into the batter's box and will await the 2-1. Low and away, and a 3-1 hitter's count for Gronholz. As I'd like to see him unload on one. If you see something he likes here, the 3-1, check swing, too low, ball 4. They check. Oh, they said he went. Oh, no. Heading back to the batter's box is Kip Gronholz, and the count will go full. I don't know about that one. The count remains full with one out, as the outfielder will have to dig back in and see another 3-2 pitch. Clare delivers home. This one low and away. No check swing there, as he'll head down to first base. And there will be a runner on with one away. Clay Cutter rounds out the order in the 9 spot. He'll hit with a runner on first base, one away, after his RBI double in his last AB. Other than that, a 1-for-3 night. That one gets away from Boyd, scooting up to second base, and the catcher finally scrambling to the ball, so Gronholz will only get as far as second on another wild pitch. As we'll count up the wild pitch total at the end of the game, but it is up there tonight for the Horseheads. And the Pios certainly capitalizing. Runner on second base in Gronholz. With one away, pitch home from Clare. Now sinked out into the left center gap, ranging back as the left fielder. He'll pull up at the wall and watch it fly. A 2-run home run from Clay Cutter following his RBI double in the bottom of the 5th. And with some family in attendance tonight, Cutter putting on a show with that 2-run bomb. Cross the plate and put on the sombrero as the Pios now lead 14-7. Western Nebraska scoring in each of their last 4 innings and in 5 of the 6 in which they've come to bat so far. So after a start to the season where the first couple series, we didn't see a lot of home runs for the Pioneers. They've suddenly turned on the power switch, and we've seen some bombs as of late as Smelko tries to hit one there but comes up empty on a breaker for strike one. And with one out, it'll be top of the order for the Pios. This pitch to Clare, low, chased by Smelko, and the count now 0-2. On the switch hitting center fielder, who has 2 hits on the day, 7 on the series. He has been red hot at the plate, 7-for-14. The righty winds and delivers this 0-2 breaking ball, a beauty, as Smelko will go down on strikes for out number 2. That is Clare's first. As he tries to compose himself after the home run, he'll face Dalton Frank. Tough batter to face as he is just as hot as Smelko. 2 hits on the day, also has a walk, a pair of runs. And hard to forget his 2-for-3 day last night. With two double, or the double and the 2-run walk-off homer to clinch the series against the Horseheads. Watch this breaking ball catch the outer half for strike one. Here's the 0-1. That one off the plate too far, and that'll even the count on the freshman from Loxahatchee, Florida, at Florida Atlantic University, older brother in the Rays organization. As the count even at one apiece, this one, another breaker off the end of the bat, jammed towards short, or towards first, a spinner, and the toss to first, dead, and ruled, I don't know what they're ruling, a fair ball by the home plate umpire. Oh boy, another confusion between these two umpires. Paul Sedekase trying to plead his case. I've never seen a situation where both teams are unhappy with a call, but that's the situation. And Casper thinks it would have been an out had it been called fair, but it would have been a close play at first base. Some more conversation. And now Casper's going to walk off the field. What a scene here at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. Antonio Garcia is trying to get an explanation on what the situation is, as it was a close play at the first base bag, but the first base umpire never made a call. I think the first base umpire may have thought that it was fouled off of a piece of Dalton Frank, meaning it was a foul ball, but that wasn't the case. It was a spinner off the end of the bat, having a similar reaction, I guess, but the home plate umpire is responsible for that call. So interesting here, but regardless, it'll end the inning. And Antonio Garcia, I'm sure, will get his words in. Have to be careful out there, as the Pioneers do enjoy a 7-run lead. And we head to the top half of the 7th inning. Pios play two more on the 2-run home run from Clay Cutter. And we'll be back in a moment on KNEB.
Good luck, Western Nebraska Pioneers, from the A. Elliott Law Office. A. Elliott Law is located at the Railway Office Plaza on the corner of Railway Street and Avenue B in Scotts Bluff, Suite C110. Needing legal counsel for criminal law, juvenile law, real estate, estate planning, probate and domestic, and family law? Call Audrey Long today for an appointment, 633-5294. A. Elliott Law supports the Western Nebraska Pioneers.
Rainbow!
Oh, that? That's the sound of someone at Papa Murphy's using fresh ingredients to make your pizza. And this, yes, is the sweet sound of your oven timer telling you that your home-baked Papa Murphy's pizza is done. Because at Papa Murphy's, we believe that Tuesday deserves something different. Like your new way of telling your family pizza is ready.
Come and get it!
Okay. Every Tuesday, get any large pizza for just $10. Papa Murphy's. Change the way you pizza.
Wonderful warmer weather, sunshine, and blue skies bring new life, growth, and so much beauty along with it. Get out and make new memories this summer. Enjoy the great outdoor activities available to us right outside our back door, including walking, biking, hiking, running, fishing, camping, and more. Take time this summer to enjoy all the good life has to offer in the panhandle of Nebraska. And remember to wear sunscreen. This message is brought to you by Prime Mental Products.
KNEB 960 AM, and now on 100.3 FM.
So after a wild ending to the bottom of the 6th inning, we're back now for the top of the 7th as Teddy Broxerman's first pitch home misses outside for ball one. His second is now popped up foul to the right side to even the count at 1-1. Joe Schmidt at the plate, the cleanup man tonight for the Casper Horseheads, is 1-for-2 as a single, a walk and a run, and a strikeout. Rockstrom in the lefty, comes home. This breaking ball dropping low outside, and the count moving to 2-1. Schmidt chasing it down himself, beating Antonio Garcia to that ball. And play will continue after this 2-1. Rockstrom in sets, comes home. This one will find the zone after a swing and miss from Joe Schmidt, evens the count at 2 apiece. The 6'2", 225 freshman at John A. Logan will have to protect here. The 2-2 home from Broxerman. This one dribbled slowly back up towards the mound, fielded by Broxerman, and a long underhanded flip to first is in time for out number one. Brooks Browning at the dish now. Struck out looking to open the game. He reached on what was ruled an error, at least in my book.
Now the play from Regis University.
Yes, it could have been a double play. A chance from Cutter to field it in front of the bag. He was moving towards the mound but had to flip towards Kellen Rutz covering second base and couldn't get it there as Rutz couldn't field it cleanly. That one swung on and missed for strike one. Regardless, he came around to score in that four-run top of the fourth. And outside of that, he had an RBI single in the fifth. 0-1 count now as Brockstrom deals and delivers this one. Off the plate low, 1-1 now on the DH. Browning, 1-for-5 entering tonight with the RBI double, which nearly left the yard. Swings and misses at this fastball and a heavy hack from Browning. But he'll come up empty. The count moves to 1-2. Browning from Regis University, where he's landed after a season of community college at Lynn Benton. The 1-2 home, breaker, swung on and missed. And that's a strikeout, out number two in this one. Two quick outs for Teddy Brockstrom as he tries to find the third here in this top of the seventh inning. On the West Coast scoreboard, the Pioneers lead 14-7. They have 30 runs this season, 30 runs this series against Casper.
Now at the play from Georgia State University, Preston Joy.
In the three games that they've played, as the first pitch home from Brockstrom is a broken bat. Brockstrom, look out, that barrel shot out towards the mound, but it's a line drive into the glove of Cade McGee, and it'll be out number three. So three up, three down as the top of the seventh wraps up. It's time to stretch at Oregon Trail Park Stadium as we'll head to the bottom half. Pio's leading by seven. Stay with us. You're listening to Pio's Baseball on KNEB.
At Monument Physical Therapy, their purpose is to find the root of your problem, not to chase your symptoms. Disc and nerve pain, sports and work injuries, muscular skeletal disorders, and dizziness or balance issues are all very common, but you don't need to live with them. Monument Physical Therapy uses the most current, evidence-based, and board-certified orthopedic standards of care. Don't let months go by before getting to the source of your pain. Call them today at 308-633-5361 or visit them on Facebook.
Recent moisture has weeds off to a great start in area corn and beet fields. Studies show early weed pressure is one of the greatest detriments to yield in all growing crops. Protect your investment by contacting Westco and developing a weed control program that best fits your operation. Your Westco sales agronomist will help you determine the best options for your crop and set up timely application. Westco has the products, the equipment, and the knowledge to meet your crop needs. Call one of our six locations in the Wyobraska area today. Westco, service, solutions, success.
Katie, remember the day you made me the happiest man alive? I asked if you wanted to live to the fullest, to wake up every morning savoring potato olays, fluffy scrambled eggs, and breakfast burritos from Taco John's, and you said...
Get your hands off my burrito.
Oh, Katie, I love when you whisper sweet nothings.
Wake up and go with bigger, bolder, better breakfast, only at Taco John's.
Drive-thru open at 6 a.m., dining room open at 8. Taco John's, with locations on Scotts Bluff, Gearing, and Bridgeport.
KNEB 960 AM, and now on 100.3 FM.
Bottom of the seventh inning about to come your way. The Pios trying to add to their lead as they lead this one 14-7. Monument Physical Therapy in Garing offers the Bumps and Bruises program, offering one free consultation and one free follow-up for all area athletes. Monument Physical Therapy in Garing. It'll be Cade McGee. We'll lead it off here. He has a pair of walks, three runs, and a two RBI single tonight. 1-for-2 is stat line as that breaking ball drops into the inside half for strike one. Reading the live chat here, Michael Felton out of the lineup. And done with the Pioneers for the season after his temporary status is up. As that breaking ball drops low, the count moves to 1-1. Was signed as a temporary player, so his contract ended. And he has wrapped up his season, but it was a stellar season for the catcher. As the 2-1 home. This one popped foul out of play, and the count moves to 2-2. Felton, in the 9 games of work, had a .412 average, 14 hits, 5 extra bases, and 8 RBIs, currently listed as second on the team in average overall. As this breaking ball misses inside on McGee, the count goes 3-2. The man with first in that category is Jake English, the catcher, who should be back with the Pios in a little bit. After having to take a trip home, here's the 3-2. Breaking ball, that one misses inside. Ball 4, and a leadoff walk for Cade McGee kicks off this bottom of the 7th inning. The highest average on the team among active players is Charlie Deeds, in 7 games has a .385 average, but he's only had 13 at-bats. So among those with more significant time at the dish, it's Tyler Garrity, a .355 rate, 11 hits and 31 at-bats. As JT Walden now smokes one into right field. Long way to go for the right fielder. It'll bounce on the warning track before the wall. They're going to send the runner around third. Now hold him as JT Walden sends a bullet of a double, a foot shy of a 2-run home run. Brian Webb will step up to the plate now. Back-to-back lefties against Will Clare, as JT Walden, starting yesterday, had no extra base hits on the season, had a long double. Had a double that was shot down the right side and hit one of the white signs out there in right field, but was ruled foul, which was unbelievable as it is. And then he followed that foul ball, in quotation marks, on the next pitch, hit a rocket to a deeper part of the park for a double. He then hit a solo home run later that game and now has the double. That's 3 extra base hits in 2 games, and JT Walden is heating up, which could be a bad sign for the rest of the Expedition League, as Walden certainly has the power and tools to be a star player for the Pioneers this season. As up at the plate is Brian Webb. He's down in the count now, 0-2. Runners on second and third for the Pios as Clare comes home. This one off the plate, and the count goes to 1-2. One-two count as the righty will come home to Brian Webb. This one popped up into shallow center field. It actually won't even get that far. Still on the infield dirt. And shortstop Preston Joy reels it in for out number 1. Exactly what the doctor ordered out there on the mound for Will Clare, as he gets the first out and the runners stay put at second and third. So Pioneers hitting, another area where they could use some work is their situational hitting with less than 2 outs. You see a lot of times the runners on second and third are bases loaded and no outs or 1 out, and the Pios can't get the job done. But then they'll get it done with 2 outs, because their 2 out hitting has been really impressive, as the wind's starting to pick up now, blowing heavy out towards left field. Maybe a good omen for Nate Schwartz. This one misses off the plate for ball 2. Ball 1, rather. 1-1 count on the right-handed hitting catcher in his first start as a Pio. Watches this breaking ball drop in for strike 2 as the count goes to 1-2. And I'm sure you can see it on the broadcast if you're watching, but some of the dirt in the outfield warning track blowing up. And the flag in left field is nearly coming off the pole. This 1-2 in the dirt, swung on and missed. The throw to first base is in time. And 2 outs with 2 in scoring position. The third strikeout of the night for Nate Schwartz after his two RBI single, which opened the day. And now it's Kellen Rutz's time to bat. He has an RBI already, also a walk. Eric Arado, second baseman, playing the batter, Kellen Rutz, to pull here. Left-handed hitting shortstop tonight. As the 0-1 home from Claire, that one just misses on the outer half, evening the count at 1-1. Cade McGee started with a walk, and then the double from JT Walden put the runners on second and third with nobody out, and now two quick outs have left the runners where they are. As that one misses inside, the count now moves to 2-1. Home, swung on and missed. Rutz, heavy hack there, but he comes up empty. The count even at 2-2. Deuces wild, runners on second and third. Two on, two out, 2-2 count to Kellen Rutz. Here's the pitch. Oh, ball three. Everybody started walking off the field, but they didn't get the call. I'm sure Landon Boyd unhappy. He had a conversation with the home plate umpire in his at bat. And now behind the dish, not getting that call, and I'm sure not happy. So instead of the strikeout to end the inning, the count is full, 3-2, two away. Claire will have to throw another. Here it is. This one shot down the left field line. Will it stay fair? It will not. Just going foul. Antonio Garcia doing the full windmill there as he was sending everybody home. Walden would have scored standing up had that dropped in fair territory, but it does go foul. Kellen Rutz, another life. Runners on second and third, two outs and a 3-2 count. Nice night for baseball at Oregon Trail Park Stadium. It was hot at first pitch, but it has since cooled off as the sun has set and the breeze blowing. Here's the 3-2, this one off the plate, away. Ball four, and a really nice at bat from Kellen Rutz as he will walk to load the bases. Kip Gronholz at the plate, has scored a run in his last two plate appearances. Struck out to start the game tonight, was hit by a pitch in the third, then caught stealing. Had a single in the fifth and scored a run, then walked in the sixth and scored a run. That one missing for ball one. Some arms warming up for Casper in the runs of visitors bullpen. Here's the 1-0 home. Missing inside, the count 2-0 now. Count. Claire comes home. Hitters count. This one now shot out into left field on a line. The left fielder has to move back a little bit. Luke Quick. A rocket off the bat of Gronholz, but it was right at Luke Quick. And so that will wrap up this bottom of the seventh inning. The Pios leave the bases loaded. And no runs cross the plate after a leadoff walk and double. Put two in scoring position with nobody out. But the Pios exit with no runs on the board. They still lead by seven as we head to the top of the eighth inning. New arm in the game. We'll have information about the new pitcher right on the other side. You're listening to Pios Baseball on KNEB.
Make your summer more rewarding with a Visa Rewards credit card from Platte Valley Bank. Earning 1% cash back on purchases means more ice cream, flip-flops, sunscreen, pool floaties, or whatever you need to make your summer a little cooler. With no annual fee, no balance transfer fee, and the security of having your local bank behind you, a Platte Valley Bank Visa Rewards credit card just makes sense for you this summer and for many summers to come. Apply online today at www.pbbank.com.
Platte Valley Bank, member FDIC. Subject to credit approval. Certain restrictions may apply.
Kylie is a Runza burger lover.
Especially if it's smothered with sautéed onions and French onion dip and topped with Swiss cheese.
Oh, sounds like you just had the French onion burger at Runza.
Yes. Yes, I did.
Are you crying?
Yeah, it's the onions.
Wait, are you crying?
Yeah, because I love the French onion burger.
Come get yours today. Because from the way we make it to the way it makes you feel, Runza makes it all better.
Behind every farm and ranch is a family. At J.G. Elliott Insurance Center, we treat all our clients like family. I'm Lex Larson, Farm and Ranch Insurance Producer. Together, we will work side by side to get to know you and your operation. We can provide comprehensive coverage for your farm, ranch, machinery, livestock, and so much more. The right insurance can help protect your family, your future, and keep your operation running in every season. Give me a call at 308-635-2023 or stop by our office in Scottsbluff.
J.G. Elliott Insurance Center, a Platte Valley company.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Contact Jennifer Yurdialis, your local five-star lender with Castle and Cook Mortgage. For a simple, friendly, and fast loan process for your home purchase or refinance, contact Jennifer today. Castle and Cook Mortgage, the key to your castle. New arm into the game to kick off this top of the eighth inning. It's Trent Richter, who will have his third appearance of the season, has three innings under his belt, allowing three hits, four runs, three of them earned, one walk, a pair of strikeouts, but a 1-0 record for Richter, as he will face the 7-8-9 in the order for the Casper Horseheads, starting with catcher Landon Boyd, who has a 1-for-2 day, walked, singled, and scored two runs. First pitch home from Richter, this one in there, strike one. 12 hits tonight for the Pioneers to the 5 for the Casper Horseheads. That one in the dirt. And the count evening at 1-1. So only 3 of those hits coming against Caden Edwards. As the 1-1 home, this one swung on and just getting a piece is Boyd. He'll fall behind 1-2. Wind still blowing this time. Really heavy. The pole starting to shake out there. Straight away to left field. Disadvantage for the lefties, advantage for the righties. As the count moves to 2-2 after that misses. I'm sure you're starting to see some of the dust and dirt of the infield kick up. Here's the 2-2. Ooh, that one missed the spot, but it might have caught the inside corner. And because Schwartz having to reach back across the body to field that one, it's called a ball, even though it might have crossed the plate. The count full, 3-2. Richter comes home. This one swung on, dribbled up the first baseline, but it does go foul. That one much more inside. But fouled away. 3-2 pitch home from Richter. Ball four, that one just missing on the outer half. And a leadoff walk for Landon Boyd, who had a pretty good AB. We'll bring up Ricky Teal to keep the line moving. He singled and scored in his last AB. He's also lined out and struck out in his three at-bats tonight. And it is really windy here. I know I've said it a lot, but it keeps getting windier. Not sure if you can see it on the live stream, but you can just see the dirt just blowing underneath the lights out there. That one misses low. Nice pick behind the plate by Schwartz. And it's moving pretty quickly. And the pickoff to first base, diving back safely, is Landon Boyd. One oh count, nobody out here as Richter looks for the first out in this top of the eighth inning. Pitch home, that one in there, strike one. 1-1 count. Last inning was a 1-2-3 inning for Teddy Brockstrom, who went 2.1 tonight. Pickoff to first base again, but this time Boyd will get back without a slide. 1-1 home from the righty Richter. This one shot out into left field, and that wind's going to help blow it. Left fielder ranges back, but it goes over his head and off the wall. JT Walden throws into the cutoff man, but a no-out double puts runners on second and third with nobody out. Elsewhere around the Expedition League, the Sioux Falls Sunfish took down the Pierre Trappers by a score of 10-9. Close one there at Karras Park in Sioux Falls. Fremont move falling to the Hastings Sodbusters by a score of 7-6. The Sodbusters coming in and closing that one out. So Fremont falling down again. The Canyon County Spuds holding on to a 3-2 lead in the top of the seventh against the Tommyknockers. And with Spearfish having the day off, Richter brings this one home. It finds the zone for strike one. With Spearfish having the day off, if the Pioneers can win this game, they top them and move to second in the Clark Division. And if Fremont falling to 11-3, Pios will be one game back of them to go play Hastings. That one misses off the plate, and the count evens at 1-1. Playoffs decided by whoever wins the first half and second half in each division. As the 1-1 home, this one now popped up high, foul behind the press box for strike two. Right-handed pitcher Trent Richter out of Western Nebraska Community College, the Scottsbluff, Nebraska native. We'll bring home a 1-2 here. That one just missing on the outer half. A good pitch, but it moves the count to 2-2. Richter pitching against his former team, played in 2019 with the Casper Horseheads in their inaugural season, but he never beat the Pios and has now joined the Pioneers as this one's fouled again. And Luke Quick continues to stay alive. Two RBI single, a strikeout, and a walk for Luke Quick to this point. As the righty brings this 2-2 home. This one shot foul out of play, and the count remains where it is. I got a fever, and the only prescription is more cowbell. Two-two count. Richter comes home. That one off the plate. 3-2 now as the righty is a pitch away from loading the bases. Action for the Pioneers in the bullpen. As the 3-2 home, this one chopped foul again. And Luke Quick is putting together one heck of an at-bat to stay alive. As the Pioneers need six more outs to close this one out. They lead by 7. But it's the walks that kill you. And the leadoff walk now on third base as Quick fouls another one off and continues to stay alive. The count still is full. 3-2. To the left-handed hitting Luke Quick. As Richter having to do a lot of work if he wants out number one against the 9-hole hitter. Here's the pitch. This one popped up again and again out of play. The outfielder from University of Oklahoma. Everybody clap your hands. From Moore, Oklahoma, where he attended Westmore High School outside Oklahoma City. All conference in high school, led his team to the Class 6A state championship game in 2015 and 17. 3-2 to him, that one missing low and in. And a great at-bat for Luke Quick as he draws the walk, and the bases are loaded now for the Casper Horseheads. As Eric Arado and the top of the order for the Horseheads will try and get things done. 7 runs to work with here and not even a conversation on the mound from Antonio Garcia as he walks out of the dugout and instantly points towards the reliever. And it will be Hayden Mulva out of the pen to try and shut things down. Conversation with Trent Richter out there, who entered into the game, led up a walk, a double, and now another walk to load the bases, and he did not get an out here in this top of the eighth. He'll exit the mound. And coming into pitch is Hayden Mulva as he'll try and clean up this bases loaded jam. Mulva, his first two appearances of the season, first three were fantastic. His fourth is where he got into a little bit of trouble. So in 8.2 innings of work, he has eight hits allowed, four earned runs, four walks, but 10 strikeouts, a 1-0 record. The time he truly struggled was in the Mining City Tommyknockers series in a game where Pioneers were already losing by a significant margin. And the Tommyknockers adding those four runs against them. Hayden Mulva, the sophomore. And second Southwest Minnesota State pitcher in this game tonight. From Norwood Young America, Minnesota. He went to Norwood Young America Central High School. Two-time All-Conference there. Was 10-3 going into his senior year, but it was canceled. High school career consisted of 99 strikeouts and 73 innings of work. A 3.06 ERA. Five starts at Southwest Minnesota State this year. An 0-3 record in 28 innings of work. Had a 4.82 ERA, 28 strikeouts. Mulva will have to face top of the order with bases loaded, nobody out. One of the worst positions that you can come into as a reliever. But he has a 7-run cushion to work with. We've seen 8-run, 8th innings from Casper in the first series as the Pios kind of ran out of pitching.
New pitcher on the mound
and
the
walks kind of loaded up that 8th inning. Pio still won that one by a score of 15-10, but they entered that inning up 15-2. Hoping to avoid that same fate as the first pitch from Mulva is in there for a strike. And his appearance is underway. Eric Arado on the night has the sack fly. Outside of that, 0-for-3, three strikeouts. He now sends this one foul out of play. And the count 0-2 quickly as Mulva wasting no time to get ahead on the leadoff man. The right-handed throwing Mulva shakes off a sign, another one. And finally gets the one he likes before coming set and coming home. 0-2. Missing on the outer half is Mulva as that off-speed just sail to the left of home plate. He'll have to try again. Still ahead 1-2. The pitch home. This one swung on and missed. Huge strikeout for Hayden Mulva on the mound. Is out number one. The fourth strikeout of the game for Eric Arado, who struggled at the plate tonight. And that will bring up Ryan Callahan with the bases still loaded, but one away. And the double play a possibility. Mulva comes home, first pitch in there, strike one. Ryan Callahan tonight grounded out to short in his first at bat, and a nice diving play by Kellen Rutz. Struck out in his second at bat, reached on a single in the fifth, and then had the fielder's choice RBI in his most recent at bat, as this one is fouled off and into the screen for strike two.
At the plate for the Horseheads from the University of Kansas, Ryan Callahan.
0-2 count. Mulva comes set, comes home. The pitch jammed, but shot foul towards the Pio's dugout. The count 0-2. Again, Mulva shaking off signs. Finally deciding on one and brings an 0-2. Check swing, did he go? He did not. The appeal causes some disruption among the fans in attendance, but the count 1-2. Mulva again, having to work in a 1-2 count here with one away. The pitch swung on and missed. Back-to-back strikeouts from Hayden Mulva get the first two outs with the bases loaded. And now the right-hander one out away from getting out of the bases loaded, no out jam. Last hope for Casper to try and keep this one rolling in this top of the eighth is Hank Dunn. Reached on an error in his first plate appearance, struck out, reached on a fielder's choice and scored, and then was another victim of stellar play by shortstop Kellen Rutz after another diving play. First pitch swinging, he comes up empty and falls behind 0-1. Mulva shakes off another sign, and gets the one he likes before the batter steps out. Mulva wants the same pitch again. Steps on the mound. As the batter steps into the batter's box, he gets it and will come set and come home with this 0-1. This one, a slow dribbler out towards short. Going to be a tough play. Fielded by Rutz, but he has nowhere to go. An infield single as a weak ground ball again benefits the Casper Horseheads. They've had weak contact all day, but they're finding their way on base into the small zones of the ballpark that allow batters to reach. An infield single and RBI for Hank Dunn. Cuts the lead now. And this one now shot out into center field, but that will be out number three as reeling it is in Smelko. And we head to the bottom of the eighth in a 14-8 ball game. Hayden Mulva comes in, limits the damage to just a run on the weak infield single. And on the West Coast scoreboard, Pioneers on top by 6, 14-8 as we head to the bottom half. You're listening to Pio's Baseball on KNEB.
HydroZen. Unplug and recharge. What is HydroZen? It's total body relaxation. It's total body recharge. It's floating weightless on water. Floating your aches, pains, stresses, and worries away. HydroZen is a revolutionary new therapy using Epsom salt saturated water as a way to relax and rejuvenate your body. And it's now available in Scotts Bluff. It is for most ages and has many benefits to the mind and body. Visit HydroZenFloat.com or call us at 308-63-FLOAT.
Hi, I'm Austin Dillon, fleet manager at Fremont Ford in Scotts Bluff, Nebraska. I encourage all farmers, ranchers, and business owners to get in touch with me if you are looking for a new vehicle. We have specific programs through Ford that can save you a drastic amount of money on your new purchase. It would be my pleasure to discuss these savings with you. There's no better time to purchase a new work truck or personal vehicle than right now. Please get in touch with me by calling the dealership at 308-635-3701. I look forward to helping you on your new purchase.
Fun facts about owning your own hot tub, courtesy of High Plains Spas and Recreation. Relaxing in your spa before bed helps soothe your aches and pains, allowing for a deeper, more rewarding sleep. Hot Spring Spas offers features like entertainment systems with Bluetooth capability, waterfalls, LED lighting, volcano jets, and more. Yes, sleeping like a baby is just one great reason, but there's plenty more. Stay tuned or stop into High Plains Spas and Recreation, where they sell fun. Open 9 to 5 Monday through Friday, 1725 East Overland, Scotts Bluff.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
New pitcher into the game for the Horseheads as number 4 Kyle Fannin enters as the fourth arm of the day for Casper. His job will be to shut them down here in this bottom of the eighth inning and hope Casper can pull something together in the top half of the ninth. Saw it last night as the Pios entering that top of the ninth with a two-run lead and Casper scoring three in the top half. A wider deficit tonight as the Pios lead by six and still get to hit here. It'll be 9-1-2 as Clay Cutter, who has been one of the best players offensively on the night with three RBIs and a pair of runs on his double and home run. As the warm-ups are complete and Kyle Fannin will get going here. On the season for Kyle Fannin, a 158 average at the plate in eight games. Put on the mound for the two-way player. Fannin has three games played, two starts, 2.2 innings of work, nine hits, eight runs, seven of them earned, for a 23.62 ERA. Yeah, Clay Cutter tries to add to his stellar night. The right-hander, Fannin comes home. That one catches the outside part of the zone for strike one. Here's the 0-1 home. This one shot foul out to the right side. Cutter will start behind in the count 0-2. So far today, he's 2-for-4. Grounded out and struck out before his RBI double and two-run home run. As Fannin takes his time on the mound. Continues to stare down, and finally Cutter will call time. A little bit of mind games between the two. As Fannin will come home with his 0-2. Cutter at the plate awaits. The pitch. Shot down the first baseline, but goes foul. As the count remains 0-2. Cutter, 1-for-4 in game one, had an RBI and a run. Pinch ran in game two. And awaits an 0-2. The pitch swung on and missed and caught behind the plate by Landon Boyd. Second strikeout of the night for Clay Cutter is out number one here in this bottom of the eighth inning. Top of the order and Eric Smelko at the plate. As the first pitch home to him is too high, ball one. Smelko on the day has two runs, a pair of singles. As the 1-0 home now. He runs in and just misses hitting Smelko. As the count goes to 2-0. .930 here in Garing, Nebraska, as the Pios at the plate and three outs away from wrapping this one up. That one missing inside as the count moves to 3-0. Both of the first two games moving much more quickly than this one, as the 3-0 home will catch the zone. The count moving to 3-1. Game one ended by 9:20. A quick game that flew by. Casper only having four hits in that one, scoring two, and the Pioneers winning 9-2. As the 3-1 home runs in and hits Eric Smelko, he throws his bat and slowly walks down the first baseline. Rare that you see Eric Smelko angry. Seems like the most happy-go-lucky type guy that you'll ever meet. He heads down to first base with a hit-by-pitch. Game two of the series in the bottom of the ninth walk-off That one ended by 9:37. So if Casper can pick up two outs
now at the plate for your
and
Pios,
then the Pios shut down in the other half Dalton in the next Rick. 3 minutes, then we'll tie that rate. But I don't think that's too likely. First pitch home now to Dalton Frank is swung on and popped high into center field. Center fielder Ricky Teal comes all the way in and catches it. And first pitch swinging is out number two as Dalton Frank goes down on the fly out. And that'll bring up Cade McGee to try and keep the inning moving. McGee on the day has a two RBI single, a pair of walks, and three total runs. Actually has three walks. He's one for two on the day and five plate appearances as the first pitch home to him. Off outside, ball one. Smelko leads off of first base. Again, tied for the stolen base lead. Wouldn't be surprised to see him go. As here comes the 1-0. This one popped up high, foul out of play. As the count evens at 1-1. Here comes the 1-1. That one high and away. The count now moves to 2-1 here. And Oregon Trail Park Stadium. Hydrotex is your lubrication solution partner, a member of the Holiday family of companies. Hydrotex is proud to support local athletes as the 2-1 is popped high and foul, and it will get out of play at the last second. And the count will even at 2-2 on Cade McGee. Here comes the 2-2 pitch home with two away, the runner on first in Smelko as Kyle Fannin tries to get out of this bottom of the eighth scoreless. That one just misses off the edge of the plate and will have a full count. Smelko will get a head start as he's reminded by first base coach Trent Kiefer. Smelko takes his lead. Fannin brings to the belt and brings the 3-2 home. That one off the plate, ball four, and the inning will continue after the two-out walk to Cade McGee. He'll bring up JT Walden, who's had himself a pretty good day at the dish. Hit by pitch in the first, came across to score, flew out to left in his second AB. He then walked and scored in the fourth, walked and was left stranded at third in the fifth, and doubled in the seventh. As he has four hits on the series, make it five with his double. And he'll hit with two outs and runners on first and second now. Fannin comes set and brings home. Misses high, ball one. Antonio Garcia giving instruction to Eric Smelko. Count on Walden, the 6-4 left-handed hitting outfielder out there and left tonight as the 1-0 home. Misses up and in, and he'll have a hitter's count, 2-0. As the righty comes home. This one swung on and hit high out into right field. Right fielder still moving under this one and ranging all the way back to the track before pulling it in just shy of the wall. The J.T. Walden flyout wraps up this bottom of the eighth inning, and the Pios leave two stranded, but head to the top of the ninth with a six-run lead as they try and close this one out. On the West Coast scoreboard, the Pios lead 14-8. You're listening to Pios Baseball on KNEB.
Dooley Oil has been providing great service since 1968. You can find us located at 2475 North 10th Street in Erie. Hi, this is Brian from Dooley Oil. With springtime fast approaching, we have hydraulic, coolant, engine oil, and grease in stock. Our drip oil and blue ribbon depth comes in a variety of sizes, from 2.5s to totes. Delivery available. So for all your ag, commercial, lubricant, and fuel needs, trust the folks at Dooley Oil. Thank you for your patronage. Dooley Oil, committed to you.
8-year-old Lucas Ritz had a life jacket on and the close supervision of his mother when he was killed while swimming in their marina. The boat plugged into the shore power was leaking electricity, and Lucas swam into the energized water. His father urges everyone to learn from their tragedy and help keep water recreation safe.
Electrocuted in the water from a leaky boat while touching absolutely nothing. Please, please, educate yourself about electric shock drowning.
See their story at safeelectricity.org. Brought to you by Chimney Rock and Roosevelt Public Power Districts, your Touchstone Energy Partners.
Now is the time to get all your school spirit gear, and the place to get everything you need is Logos in Gearing. School spirit is what they do at Logos. Whether you're a bulldog, a bearcat, or a tiger, they've got everything you need, from sweats to hats, and of course, t-shirts and sweatshirts. Need something for the entire team? Stop into Logos, and the guys will custom design it, print it, and have it ready for the game. There is no job too big or small for Logos. Logos in downtown Gearing.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Floyd's Truck Center, your commercial farm and feed truck center, representing Freightliner, Western Star, and Harsh, 322 South Beltline Highway East in Scottsbluff. That's Floyd's Truck Center as the first pitch home from Mulva is in there for strike one on Brooks Browning, the five-hole hitter. As things are underway here in the top of the ninth inning, the Pios trying to secure the three-game sweep of the Casper Horseheads. Swinging and missing at that one is Browning, and he falls behind 0-2. Brooks Browning, a pair of strikeouts, a reach on error and run, and an RBI single in this one. As here comes the 0-2 from Mulva. That one just missing inside, but the count goes to 1-2. Mulva entering into the top of the eighth inning with the bases loaded, nobody out. Got a pair of strikeouts and then an infield single scored the only run that would score in that scenario after a flyout to Joe Schmidt in the inning. And Mulva's stellar relief appearance leaves us at the score now. We are at 14-8 as this 2-2 is just fouled back. Browning stays alive.
I got a fever and the only prescription is more cowbell.
Brooks Browning, the Casper, Wyoming native, awaits the 2-2. Curveball called strike three. A beauty that drops into the zone. And a looking strikeout is out number one here in this top of the ninth inning. Three strikeouts in the four outs that Hayden Mulva has gotten tonight. He has been a strikeout pitcher the whole year, and he's been good at it. Racking up the strikeout total in minimal innings pitched. I say minimal, but he has got a significant amount on the mound. This off speed speeds up the bat of Preston Joy. He swings and misses for strike one. Mulva, 10 strikeouts entering into the night, now at 13. As that one just misses off the plate, and the count moves to 1-1. Preston Joy on the day, 0-4, reached on an error and came around to score, but that's all doing for him as he swings and misses at that one. And the count moves to 1-2. The shortstop out of Georgia State behind in the count now. And Mulva searching for another strikeout. Righty, Wines delivers the 1-2 breaker. This one shot foul at the Casper dugout. Preston Joy 1-7 on the season with a double, a run, and three strikeouts, four after this one tonight. Swings and misses at that one and make it five. Hayden Mulva continues to rack up the strikeouts. Back-to-back Ks here in the top of the ninth. and the Pios are one out away from winning this one. Landon Boyd at the plate now. He scored three runs today. Swings and misses at this one for strike one. Three of the eight that Casper has put up. Walked twice, singled once, and grounded out to first in his other AB. That one catches the zone, and the count moves to 0-2.
All right, fans, let's give up some of that Western Nebraska funding.
0-2 count. Here's the pitch from Mulva. Swung on and missed. Hayden Mulva strikes out the side in the top of the ninth. Gives a head nod to his dugout, hypes up his boys, and the Pioneers take this one by a score of 14-8 to get the series sweep of the Casper Horseheads. They move to 10-4 on the year, 8-1 at home, and 5-1 on the year against Casper. After this one, they'll hit the road tomorrow morning, head to Hastings for a three-game set there, and the Pios are rolling as they take sole possession of second place in the Clark Division, one game behind the Fremont Moo, and they are hot as can be in this one. They'll have the runs of postgame show coming up next. Talk to our Taco John's player of the game. It'll be Clay Cutter if we can get him for this postgame interview. And the Pioneers wrap this one up with a 14-8 win. Stay with us for this runs of postgame show, but that's all for this game. To Pio's Baseball on KNEB.
We can sum up McDonald's new crispy chicken sandwich in one word. Crispy. But also juicy. And tender. Okay, it's crispy, juicy, tender. All one word. But then, also pickle. Oh, and potato bun, which is two words. Okay, we can't sum up our new crispy chicken sandwich in one word, so you'll just have to try it to understand it. Order ahead on the McDonald's app at participating McDonald's. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Wonderful warmer weather, sunshine, and blue skies bring new life, growth, and so much beauty along with it. Get out and make new memories this summer. Enjoy the great outdoor activities available to us right outside our back door, including walking, biking, hiking, running, fishing, camping, and more. Take time this summer to enjoy all the good life has to offer in the panhandle of Nebraska. And remember to wear sunscreen. This message is brought to you by Prime Mental Products.
Hi, I'm Kathy Birch from Van Newkirk Real Estate. Van Newkirk Real Estate is more than a realtor. We're your helping hand of knowledge when it comes to the investment you'll make buying that perfect home. We help you discover what's right for you and your financial situation. Whether you need commercial, residential, farm property, no one will compare to the service we're about to give you. Call one of our agents today at 632-8700 for the best real estate help possible. And we're happy to show you that service is what we sell.
Katie, remember the day you made me the happiest man alive? I asked if you wanted to live to the fullest, to wake up every morning savoring potato olays, fluffy scrambled eggs, and breakfast burritos from Taco John's, and you said,
"Get your hands off my burrito."
Oh, Katie, I love when you whisper sweet nothings.
Wake up and go with bigger, bolder, better breakfast, only at Taco John's.
Drive-thru open at 6 a.m., dining room open at 8. Taco John's, with locations on Scotts Bluff, Gearing, and Bridgeport.
Embroidery. Scotts Bluff screen printing and embroidery. We love embroidery. And now that we have a new machine, we love it even more. Stop in today and let Nikki show off your logo. With our new state-of-the-art machine, we can make any logo or design look amazing. And for a limited time, we are offering free setup fees for any new logo with a minimum of 12 items ordered. Stop in today and let us show off you. Come see us today at Scotts Bluff screen printing and embroidery, 1813 Broadway, downtown Scotts Bluff.
It's time now for the Runza post-game show, presented by Runza Restaurants. Runza makes a great stop before or after every game. Win or lose, Runza makes it all better. Now with the Runza post-game show, once again, Zach McKinstry.
Back now for the Runza post-game show. I'm Zach McKinstry. Runza doesn't like to think of themselves as just another restaurant in town. They like to think of themselves as part of the community. Runza with locations in Scottsbluff, Garing, and Chadron. The Pioneers taking this one by a score of 14-8. The Pios racking up 12 hits on four errors. Casper Horsehead, 7 hits, 1 error in this one. A stellar performance on the mound from Caden Edwards, who went 4.2 innings, allowed 3 hits, 5 runs, but none of them were earned. Allowed 2 walks, 9 strikeouts, and Teddy Brockstrom got the win after 2.1 innings of work, 2 hits allowed, 2 earned runs, a walk, and a pair of strikeouts. Impressive days at the plate from Clay Cutter, Eric Smelko, Dalton Frank, and really the majority of this Pioneers offense as they tallied 12 hits to take the 14-8 victory. Let's go around the league. The Sioux Falls Sunfish, they took down the Pier Trappers by a score of 10-9 at home in that one. The Fremont Moo falling after Hastings had a late rally to take down the Moo, and they won that one 7-6. In Canyon County, Caldwell, Idaho, the Spuds lead 3-2 in the top of the seventh in that one. And we will have our Taco John's player of the game for our interview right after this quick break. You're listening to KNEB and Pio's Baseball. Stay with us.
This is Scottsbluff President Mark Smith with Western States Bank. This 30 seconds is not long enough for me to discuss what may be the best way to overcome the business challenges you may be facing today. So let's get together. With my wealth of customized lending experience, we can work to get you what you need to continue to succeed. So with only 10 seconds left, I have time to say, find me at 1701 First Avenue in Scottsbluff.
Western States Bank, better together, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Now is the time for side dress application of dry nitrogen for this year's crops. Successful producers know a complete side dress program from Westco will ensure their corn and beets have the nutrients they need to produce top yields. Westco can custom apply your side dress fertilizer with our John Deere row crop dry spreaders and save you time to accomplish other tasks during this busy spring. Let our people and equipment help you apply dry nitrogen at a rate that best fits your goals and operation. Contact a Westco location to schedule your side dress application today. Westco, service, solutions, success.
Have you been waiting for better coverage and service? Well, that's exactly what you get when you join Vieira Wireless, the better local and national network. For a limited time, get up to $1,000 off when you trade in your phone and upgrade to one of the latest models like the iPhone 12 series. Plus, we'll give you $200 more when you port in your number. No activation or hidden fees. Learn more at your local Vieira Wireless store or at Vieira.com today.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Back now on the Runza postgame show with our Taco John's player of the game. The player of the game is brought to you by Taco John's of Scottsbluff and Garing. Make Taco John's a game day tradition by unwrapping the original before or after every game. I'm here with Clay Cutter, who had one heck of a day, including his first Pioneers home run of the season. How did that feel?
Felt great. Felt great coming off the bat.
Yeah, I thought you had family in attendance coming into the game. And then you told me before the show that they left. Tough one to leave on. Hopefully they were watching at home, huh?
Yeah, sadly they got out of town this morning, but I knew they were watching at home and had a good game, like, thankfully.
Yeah, a really good game. You had the RBI double in the sixth inning and came across to score. And you had a pretty good series, 1-for-4 in the first game of that one. And you had success against Casper in the first series, 4-for-12. In the first three games of the year. So what's the secret? What have you been doing differently against Casper that's been leading to your success?
They have good arms, and we knew that. So we knew we had to get our foot down and get ready to hit in there. I think everyone started off the season a little slow with the bats, and it's just starting to come around. We had a little break after our seasons, and it takes a little bit to kickstart it. So
how do the bats feel in the dugout when you get a starting performance? Caden Edwards picking up 9 strikeouts and exiting the game with a pretty good game.
He threw a great game. Luckily he was out there throwing a great game. Our defense didn't quite come to play today, but he was out there doing his thing, and that saved us.
Yeah, and the bats picking it up, 12 mm-hmm. hits on the day. How does it feel as an offense to get all of those hits together, everyone producing top to bottom in the lineup?
It seems to happen quite often. It's either we get no hits or we get just about 20 and everyone's hitting. So it's definitely fun when the bats are on, and we just need to keep striving to be consistent.
Yeah, well, everybody's on the same page, so at least there's that. Mm-hmm. Heading into Hastings, a three-game set on the road, and with Fremont dropping their game now, one game back of first place, hunting down that first place spot. What does it mean to secure this sweep?
Oh, these next three games are big. We got to take everyone day by day and just keep playing our game, keep swinging the bats and trusting our pitchers.
All right, Clay, thanks for coming up here, and congratulations on your good day.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And that wraps up the post-game interview. We'll have one more segment to wrap up this game and wrap up the scores around the league. We'll be right back after this break on KNEB.
Spring has sprung, and High Plains Spas and Recreation remind you that it's time to dewinterize your boats and RVs. The professionals at High Plains Spas and Recreation not only dewinterize your system, that's flushing the antifreeze, protecting your plumbing in your RV and the cooling system in boats, but they can repair and service all the systems, including the electrical, EC, and heating and plumbing, to ensure that your boat or RV is ready to go when you are. High Plains Spas and Recreation, open 9 to 5, Monday through Friday, 1725 East Overland, Scotts Bluff.
Behind every farm and ranch is a family. At J.G. Elliott Insurance Center, we treat all our clients like family. I'm Lex Larson, Farm and Ranch Insurance Producer. Together, we will work side by side to get to know you and your operation. We can provide comprehensive coverage for your farm, ranch, machinery, livestock, and so much more. The right insurance can help protect your family, your future, and keep your operation running in every season. Give me a call at 308-635-2023 or stop by our office in Scottsbluff.
J.G. Elliott Insurance Center, a Platte Valley company.
Hi, I'm Austin Dillon, fleet manager at Fremont Ford in Scottsbluff, Nebraska. I encourage all farmers, ranchers, and business owners to get in touch with me if you are looking for a new vehicle. We have specific programs through Ford that can save you a drastic amount of money on your new purchase. It would be my pleasure to discuss these savings with you. There's no better time to purchase a new work truck or personal vehicle than right now. Please get in touch with me by calling the dealership at 308-635-3701. I look forward to helping you on your new purchase.
KNEB 960 AM and now on 100.3 FM.
Back now as we wrap up the Runza postgame show, the Western Nebraska Pioneers taking this one by a score of 14-8 over the Casper Horseheads to advance to 10-4 on the year after the sweep. And they are rolling as they head into Hastings. We'll be there for the next 3 days as they take on the Sodbusters, who just came off two wins against the Fremont Moo, a tough task so far in this early season. We'll see how the Pioneers fare. We'll be there on first pitch tomorrow, and you can listen live on KNEB 960 AM 100.3 FM. That wraps up our broadcast. Thanks for everyone that's listened, and for everyone involved in the broadcast, I'm Zach McKinstry, and we'll see you all tomorrow.
This has been the